Never in human history has so few taken so much from so many as America's Illuminati and their warlords of Wall Street and Washington. In just 8 years, these banksters and international government gangsters took us from the greatest creditor nation to the largest debtor nation on Earth. Our standard of living has dropped like a rock for 4 out of every 5 Americans. They have foreclosed on our homes, our farms, our factories. They've exported your jobs and surrendered our arms.
They want it.
Well, folks, I'm going to cut this short because we got a lot to talk about tonight. I mean, a lot to talk about. I got to tell you, this is the biggest bullshit election I've ever seen in my entire life. In the first place, it's the first election where the major media has ever discussed or even mentioned the Electoral College in any way whatsoever. And the Electoral College is the big focus of all of the networks, all of the media in this election, which makes me think that they're going to force this to the Electoral College. And if that's a fact, if that's the truth, and if they've never, ever played up to the Electoral College before, and they haven't, then that means this whole election is rigged. And it's beginning to look like that's exactly the case. And I'm going to cite tonight an awful lot of information from NMS. See, I'm already starting to convert to the new name. I'm going to cite tonight from MSNBC, which I have changed the name to BSNBC. You see, MS means Microsoft National Broadcasting Corporation. It's a partnership between the two, according, you know, to what I've been told. But I'm changing it tonight to Bullshitters of the National Broadcasting Communists, because that's what I'm seeing. This is the most incredible deception that has ever played itself out in front of the American people. And the people who are sitting in the chairs on this network either are absolutely stupid, in other words, talking heads, or they are partners in absolutely going for the full total support of Al Gore, which means Marxist socialism. Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not for George Bush either, but I'm not for lies and I'm not for deception. I am totally against those things wherever they present themselves in whatever manner they are presented. And I'm telling you right now, tonight on BSNBC, this is a total deception. And I'm going to talk about this. And those of you who are not watching BSNBC, you need to tune to it because there's a show going on there that you don't want to miss. It's a classic propaganda deception job meant to con the American people into believing that Al Gore has already won the election. And nothing could be farther from the truth. Nothing could be farther from the truth. When I picked it up tonight, and, you know, certain polls were closing on the East Coast, and they began to show the results of these things, it became obvious to me that something was terribly wrong when, with only 1% of the returns counted in the state of Georgia, they gave it to George Bush. How could they give the entire state of Georgia to George Bush if only 1% of the votes had been counted? Now, historically, the South goes Republican. I can tell you that right now. And maybe that's what they were thinking of, but I don't think so. I think what they're doing is giving states with smaller electoral votes to Bush and larger electoral votes to Gore, whether or not the total vote count is going to reflect what they're telling the American people. Because whatever the networks tell the American people is what the American people, or sheeple, I should say, will believe. The next thing I saw was one of the most incredible hoaxes I have ever seen in my entire life. With only 3% of the votes in the state of Florida counted, they gave the state of Florida to Al Gore. Now, let me tell you something, folks. With only 3% of the votes in the state of Florida counted, they didn't say that it looks like Florida is going to go to Al Gore. That's not what they said. They didn't say that, before this night's over, we think that Gore is going to get the majority of the votes in Florida. That's not what they said. They didn't say that, well, only 3% of the votes have been counted, and it looks like at this point Al Gore's ahead. That's not what they said. They took this big blue thing that represented Al Gore, and they put it over the state of Florida, and they said, that's it, it's all over. Florida belongs to Al Gore, and Al Gore gets 25 electoral votes, and they gave Al Gore 25 electoral votes. And if you tune in to BSNBC right now, you'll see the electoral vote count in which the state of Florida is counted as an Al Gore possession. And here's the truth, folks. Just a couple of minutes before I walked into this studio and started talking into this microphone, Bush is ahead in the vote count in the state of Florida. Not only that, but Florida has a huge number of absentee ballots that have not been counted and won't be counted until tomorrow. At the earliest, could be a couple of days from now. But I'm telling you right now, the absentee vote in the state of Florida is largely a military vote. And the military is not ever going to vote for Al Gore or Bill Clinton or any Democrat because of the last 8 years of the rape of the military. And the military, you must remember, is an all-volunteer service now. Their lives depend upon turning around what Al Gore and Bill Clinton have done to the military within the last 8 years. And so the absentee ballots are going to go to George Bush. And he is shown as being ahead right now. And the BSNBC talking heads are ignoring this. In other words, when 3% of the ballots had been counted in the state of Florida, they gave the state to Al Gore. They gave 25 electoral votes to Al Gore. They hung the blue sign over the state of Florida. They said it's all over. Florida belongs to Al Gore. And ever since then, the vote count has showed that Bush owns the state of Florida. They haven't mentioned it. They've ignored it completely. They are showing the state of Missouri as being too close to call. But ever since the votes started to be counted in the state of Missouri, George Walker Bush has been 10 percentage points ahead of Al Gore. And the last time I looked, 33% of the votes were in the state of Missouri, and they're still calling it too close to call. This tells me that BSNBC is solidly on the side of the Marxist socialist Al Gore and are trying to influence the vote of all of those people who have not yet voted, and this started hours ago, ladies and gentlemen, to make them believe that Al Gore is winning the presidential election when he clearly is not. The state of Florida is going to go to Bush. The state of Missouri is going to go to Bush. The state of Tennessee is going to go to Bush. A whole lot of other states are going to go to Bush. I wouldn't even begin to predict the state of California. But I'm telling you right now, things are not as they are being projected by BSNBC, by ABC, by CBS, by CNN. The only one that you might be able to get even close to some kind of an accurate prediction is going to be Fox Television Network. And that's really weird, because Fox is the home of the big ufology alien deception. But that's the way it plays out tonight. And I got to tell you, I've never seen anything like this in my entire life. Bush, as I predicted, is leading in the popular vote, and he's going to win the popular vote. But they are skewing the electoral vote and out lying about the electoral vote. Lying about it. Go to BSNBC, and you'll see the figures flashing on the screen. And watch it. Watch all of the states. And you'll see the state of Florida, which they have already given to Al Gore, when only 3% of the votes were counted in the state of Florida. They gave the whole state to Al Gore. They have dismissed all the votes since then, have not referred to them, have not commented on them, have not even talked about them. And Bush is ahead. And that's not even counting the absentee ballots. At the exact moment that the polls closed in New York State, they declared Hillary Clinton the winner of the Senate race, even though not one single vote in the entire state of New York had even been counted. They declared Hillary Clinton the winner of the Senate race. No votes had been counted whatsoever. They have not shown any votes for the state of New York. But they declared Hillary Clinton was the winner of the race, and Hillary Clinton is going to be is the senator from New York. This is bad news, folks. This tells me that this is the most rigged election in the history of elections in this country. Now, if you don't believe it, go there and watch it for yourself. Watch on ABC. ABC's doing the same thing. So is CBS. The only place, and so is CNN, but the only place that you might be able to get some kind of an accurate, close approximation of what's really going on is on Fox Network. So far, they've been, as much as anyone can be, as truthful as possible. Doesn't mean it's going to stay that way. But BSNBC is absolutely the most deceptive, propagandized, bullshit, lying, piece of crap that's ever, gone over the airwaves, or satellite, or through cable, or however you're getting it. It is a most despicable display of Goring, remember Goring? Hitler's propaganda minister in World War II, Hermann Goring. Well, that's what he used to do, was this kind of crap. And I'm telling you, this is sickening. Now, I'm going to say this once again. I'm not for Gore, and I'm not for Bush. I'm not for either one of them. I know that both of them are going to take us into one world totalitarian socialist government eventually. Bush will do it slower. Gore will do it sooner. Gore will bring a civil war to this country much sooner than Bush ever thought of. In fact, if Bush gets elected to the White House, Bush will be out of the White House after 8 years of having served two terms before his policies even begin to institute such a clash between the American people. But Gore will bring it on really quick. Good evening. You're on the air.
Good evening, Bill. I'm not sure. I picked up a little bit late in your broadcast there, but I have something I've noticed here on all the coverage on all the channels is that they've gone and changed the color they use to represent each party.
Well,
the Republicans used to be red and the Democrats were blue.
Well, they still are on BSNBC.
They're showing Bush is having red now. It's like they're taking the Communist Red Party and trying to attach it to the fascist right.
Bush was always red on BSNBC, and Gore was always blue.
Yes. In this election, in every election before this, the Republicans.
Oh, you're talking about past. I thought you were talking about this coverage of this election.
Yeah, every single coverage network out there now has reversed the colors of the party.
It's part of the propagandizing that to make those of us who understand that red means communist, means socialism, to have this subliminal effect in our mind to reject our own candidates, even though some of us who are so well-educated, such as I, wouldn't vote for that candidate anyway.
That's exactly correct. I mean, that's what I figured was the purpose of it. But
absolutely,
it's crazy.
Well, it is crazy, but it is a fact, and it's exactly what's happening.
Well, I just wondered if anybody else had noticed that, and it's certainly part of the psyops, people working at CNN and throughout the industry.
Well, I've noticed it. Other astute people have noticed it, and it was going to come up as a subject later in this broadcast, but since you brought it up, let's talk about it now. When you see that color red for the states that George Bush is supposedly winning, what does it make you think about?
Well, certainly, immediately it struck me as the association of fascism, which is nothing but another form of communism, but nobody else seems to understand that.
Well, that may not be true, because the effect is subliminal.
Yeah,
people see that, even though it doesn't register in their conscious mind, it absolutely does register in their subconscious mind.
Well, that's my point, Bill. I took the PSYOPs course at Fort Bragg back in the 70s, and the first thing that they told us was, anything you learn here is illegal, and you'll go to Leavenworth for 20 years if you ever use it on an American civilian.
Well, they're trying to scare you, and that's a bunch of bullshit. You can use anything that they taught you as long as it's not against the law, and I guarantee you nothing that they taught you is against the law.
Well, it was just something for them to put in the course, yes, but the
because they don't want you using it against them.
Yeah, but the point is, now they're working at news desks at CNN.
Well, of course they are, and it's not just them working at a news desk at CNN. You have to understand the way. Well, you know, this could be a whole broadcast by itself. Is the way that the intelligence community, the CIA, the FBI, and other government agencies have funds that they can use to purchase a proprietary interest in corporations. And they do that. For instance, since the very beginning of CBS, when William Paley was the head of CBS, the Central Intelligence Agency has owned a proprietary interest in that corporation. They own a proprietary interest, a huge proprietary interest, I might add, in ABC. They have become a partner, and this is one of the reasons why Ted Turner, an obscure guy who owned one television station in the state of Georgia, was able to build a worldwide network called CNN. Where did that money come from? It came from the Central Intelligence Agency. Now, you won't be able to trace it to the letters CIA or the words Central Intelligence Agency. The CIA purchases proprietary companies or corporations or owns majority interest in these corporations or companies, and those companies in turn turn around and purchase stock in a fledgling media corporation called CNN, and they purchase enough stock where they have the controlling vote and they can direct exactly what goes on with that media corporation.
Well, I've sort of agreed with you in a general sort of way since you first came on the air, but my problem was I could never see the infrastructure that had to be there to pull it all together and to make it work, and those PSYOPs people in that program they call Working with Industry, they do one-year stints out there in what they call the industry, which is the news industry.
Sure.
And now I see the infrastructure.
Yeah. Well, it's there, and I guarantee you it's there.
Hey, thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome. Thank you for calling. 520-333-4578 is the number. Can you believe what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is the most incredible thing. Either they believe themselves to be so superior, or all of us to be so stupid, absolutely stupid, that we cannot see any of this, that it's beyond even the wildest expectations of even the dumbest redneck stupid farmer in the most farthest backwoods place that maybe never even graduated from the third grade. Even those people could see through this crap. Good evening, you're on the air.
Hey, Bill, I just watching these networks, and it's amazing how they called Florida with less than 1% of the vote And right now, all the networks are having to recant right now. I wonder if it was a plan from the beginning.
Absolutely it was. How can you call a state with 1% of the vote?
It's unbelievable.
Even NBC didn't try that. I mean, they waited until it got to 3%. Right. But how do you call a whole state with 3% of the vote, knowing that there's this big, huge majority, even if Gore was going to carry the state, that there's big, huge majority of absentee ballots that won't be counted for 1 or 2 days beyond tonight?
Right, it's unbelievable. I mean, in fact, right when they called the state, I'm like, what's that all about? Because even the percent numbers were way in favor of Bush. I'm not like, if I'm like you, I mean, not like Bush is going to be the best candidate, but at least like you say, we're not going to start the war. The war won't be started, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
In the Bush administration.
No, the war won't be started in the Bush administration. Bush has to have the at least the aura of preserving the principles and ideals that his constituency believes in that's going to put him in the White House.
Right. Well, it looks like it's going in his favor. I'm not so sure if that's the best thing for the company, but I think he is the less of two evils, obviously.
Well, I'm telling you right now, Bush is going to win the popular election. Whether or not he wins the Electoral College is a whole other story. And the fact that they have played this Electoral College up so much in this election and never even mentioned it in any other election, they just went strictly by the popular vote, and when the popular vote was in, they declared the winner. And they ignored the Electoral College. Most Americans never even knew there was an Electoral College, never even knew that the real vote for the president occurred over a month after the popular election until America heard it on this broadcast. And I'm telling you right now, I think that this whole strategy with the Electoral College has come out because I educated America on this broadcast about what the Electoral College is really all about and how the president is really elected, and Americans have never heard that before.
No, you're absolutely right. Okay, well, I thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thanks for calling. 520-333-4578 is the number. We'll be taking your calls for the rest of the night. And by the way, folks, before we go any further, I have to tell the people here in the Round Valley of Arizona that we've been off the air on 101.1 FM for the last 2 or 3 or 4 days. I forget how long it's been. It may have even been a week or two because I didn't discover that we really weren't going out over the antenna until, 3 or 4 days ago. It may have been longer than that. But I found what the problem was today. And I thought that we had suffered a major breakdown of some, big piece of equipment. And I troubleshot everything in the studio today. I couldn't find anything wrong with any piece of equipment. So I started following the cables, and I found out that the cable that plugs in to the back of the transmitter that goes to the antenna had somehow pulled out of the F fitting that screws into the back of the transmitter, and there was no signal going to the antenna. So that's what happened. We are back on the air tonight. We are broadcasting throughout the Round Valley, and I apologize for the inconvenience, and I want to thank all of you who live here who understand that we're operating on a shoestring and breakdowns occur, and I'm not an electronic genius. And so I thank you for your understanding and your patience and your support. Good evening. You're on the air.
Okay. Good evening, Bill. This is Mike in LaBelle, Florida, 106.7.
Hi, Mike.
I'm going to tell you what it is. I've talked to you about this before. It starts at Florida Statute 15.17. Then it goes to House Bill 1374 in 1967, and then they have a Rio de Janeiro summit meeting, and voila, the UN's been in control of every department in this state, and they did it through the banking codes. In your Department of Election, it's rigged. The OAS has been in charge for a long time.
I don't doubt that at all, but what you just said is Greek.
I know.
To the listening audience, and they don't have a clue. But we'll talk about this on some other broadcast.
Okay, I just wanted to let you know. Have a good evening.
Thank you. Thanks for calling. He's absolutely correct, folks. But we're not going to get into that tonight because it would just confuse you even more. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill. This is Matt calling from Connecticut.
Hi.
Kind of to add on to your first caller regarding the subliminal thing, another interesting thing to look at is some of the other channels, the movies that they're playing tonight. Bravo was playing all the President's Men.
Uh-huh. They're playing all these election movies and presidential movies and things where the
movie classics was showing the conversation by Gene Hackman.
Yep.
And that was right after Watergate.
Yeah, and most of these movies show the candidates in a very bad light.
Yes, of course.
Very bad light.
And then Ted Turner's turn of
And by the way, I might add that most of the candidates in these movies that they show in a very bad light are always represented, even if they don't say it, as Republican candidates.
Oh, of course. Or conservative.
Or conservative or right wing.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And then you have on Turner Classic Movies, a movie called Mr. Skeffington from 1944.
That's a very good movie, by the way.
Yeah, I had never seen it before, and I just watched about a half an hour of it because, it really just, things started to catch my ear, and it definitely has a very pro-socialist and anti-capitalistic.
Yeah, and if you read the story on my website about the meeting that they held way back when with Hollywood and the media,
what was the name of that book?
And the intelligence community is Thought Control in America.
Right. Okay. Yes, they did need that.
And there's only 500 copies ever printed, and there were only 500 delegates, and each delegate got one copy of the book.
Did it say on there when about that was written?
Yeah, but I don't have that information right in front of me, and I don't want to guess right off the top of my head because I could be wrong.
Well, I just wanted to add that. It's another thing to think about.
But it was, I'll tell you this, it was the late 40s or early 50s when this meeting occurred.
Yeah. Of course, during the McCarthy era.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you much.
Thank you for calling.
Take care.
520-333-4578 is the number. This is quite a night. I mean, if you have any intelligence whatsoever, you're watching what's going on. You just have to be standing there with your jaw dropped down in your chest. How can they think we're so bloody stupid that they're going to get away with this? Almost said it. Away with this crap. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yeah. Hi, Mr. Kirby. This is Virginia.
You don't have to tell me that. I recognize your voice. You have a very distinctive voice, and I would know you anywhere the minute you open your mouth.
Okay. I just wanted to let you know what happened here in Austin tonight. The Bush family was out to dinner, and they weren't even out an hour. They were in the restaurant, and the word came from their headquarters that something was wrong, apparently. And
they went to the mansion.
Pardon me?
They went to the mansion.
Okay. And their, I think it was their strategist or one of their election people, they called NBC and told them that it was irresponsible of them putting Gore, the credit to Gore for Florida.
Yeah, and not just Florida, but other states as well.
Right. Well, I just wanted to pass that on, and I didn't know whether you'd heard it or not, but...
Oh, yeah, I'm on top of this.
You know, I started to... I thought you were. I started seeing something wrong. It started off about 7 o'clock and everything in Central Time, and about 7:30 I started spotting this stuff, so it wasn't very long into it that they started.
Yeah, and they've given Gore all of the electoral votes of a lot of states where Bush is clearly 10 percentage points ahead in the state.
Absolutely.
And it's clear that he's going to take that. I'm going to tell you right now, see what that propaganda does?
Mm-hmm.
It's a subliminal thing that makes you start thinking a certain way. Bush is going to take Florida. Bush is going to take Missouri. Bush is going to take a lot of other states that they've already given to Al Gore. But they're going to continue to present the Electoral College votes as if Gore has already won those states.
Well, could this be put into a criminal investigation?
Well, it should be. It should be. But here's what's happening, see. They're telling America that Gore has already won the election and Bush doesn't have a chance. And that influences voters that have not gone to the polls yet, where the polls have not closed. And if they think that Bush has already lost, they won't even go out to vote.
Oh, I see what you mean. Okay.
And there's another percentage of people that if they think Bush has already lost, even though they were going to vote for Bush, they'll go vote for Gore simply because they don't want to have to ever say they voted for the loser.
Yeah. Well, will this all get straightened out eventually and Bush will be on top again?
Are you kidding me? Who knows how it's going to play out? And it's not ever going to be straightened out.
Well, I mean...
I mean, and there is, there's voter fraud is occurring all across this country. I mean, tremendous voter fraud. The governor of the state of Arkansas, the state where Bill Clinton comes from, said on a morning broadcast with Don Imus that in his state after church on Sunday, buses were picking up minority people at their churches, taking them to the polls where they voted for the president on Sunday.
That's unbelievable.
Which is against the law. They weren't supposed to vote until this morning when the polls opened.
Well,
and this is the governor of the state of Arkansas. He also made the statement that in the state of Arkansas, cemeteries open up the ground and the dead march out and vote in huge numbers by battalions. He also said on the Don Imus show that in the state of Arkansas, a lot of the ballots, the actual official ballots, were taken from the polling places to the homes of prominent Democrats in the state of Arkansas for, quote, safekeeping, end quote.
Wow.
Now, I'm not making this up.
Oh, I heard you.
This was the governor of the state of Arkansas who said these things on Imus in the Morning, which is a national syndicated talk show, and he was the guest. I was sitting there thinking, my God, how can this guy get on this radio broadcast and talk about his state and his people in that state that way, and he's not doing anything about it?
It's unbelievable.
And, you know, Don Imus asked him, he said, well, why aren't you doing anything about this? And you know what he said? He said, when the major officials of state government are Democrats, when the prosecutors in the counties and the cities are Democrats, when all the judges are Democrats, he says, what can I do about it?
What can we do about what's going on tonight? Anything?
My dear, clean your weapons. Be prepared. Clean your weapons. Be prepared to die for freedom. Make sure you got plenty of ammunition and, because it's going to come down to that. If not within the next few months, within the next few years, or if Bush is really elected, within the next 12 years.
I was hoping there'd be some way that they could...
is not going to be any political solution to the situation in which we find ourselves. They are destroying the principles and ideals upon which this nation was based that we, as true Americans, adhere to, revere, that we are sworn to protect and defend those of us who ever took that oath. And not one politician in this country is going to come to our aid. They don't have the balls to stand up and do what it takes. And if they did, they'd be assassinated or moved out or framed in some way to become some criminal or some philanderer or whatever. That's the way it works. So it's going to come down to the force of arms. If you're not prepared for that, you know, you better flee to another country because that's what's going to happen in this country. I can guarantee you that. I'll lay my life on it. It's the truth. And everybody that's got even a modicum of a brain has reached this conclusion a long time ago.
Yeah, I see it coming. Okay, Mr. Cobra, thank you.
Okay, thanks Bye-bye. For calling. Yeah, at this late stage of the game, back in the 60s, we could have done something. Not at this late stage of the game. They've subverted this country to the point where there is no political solution. They've demonized us. They've demonized the principles and ideals upon which this nation was founded. People don't even want to hear it. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill. You know, boy, this really makes me think of Alex Collier, who I saw you speak with in Lansing, Michigan.
Yeah.
And I would advise everybody out there to read that vote scam book. Because it certainly seems to be a continuation of that. I wanted to ask you, first of all, here in Michigan, Bush is ahead, and a long time ago they gave it to Gore, and they installed
That's right. That's another state, and I forgot to mention that. Right before I came into the studio, I noticed that Bush is ahead in Michigan, and they gave the state of Michigan to Al Gore.
Hours ago.
Well, it was before they even had any vote count, they gave it to Gore.
And also, they have given it...
and they gave the electoral count to Gore. That electoral count that you're seeing on the screen includes states where Bush is clearly going to win the state.
Exactly right. And they also gave it to the Democratic candidate for senator here when the Republican is well ahead.
Yeah.
Still.
This is a clear deception, folks. But you have to understand that most of the American sheeple are not looking at the numbers on the screen. See, they're showing the truth on the screen.
You know what?
So they can always say, we didn't deceive you. We showed you the numbers. If you believed what we said rather than the numbers we were showing you, then you're stupid.
Right.
That's what they're going to say if they get caught in this charade. But the truth is, most of the American sheeple are not looking at those numbers. And if they do, the numbers don't register because they believe what they're told on television. And they will not question it. If somebody says it on television, it's the truth.
Well, I also thought how the Gore camp has been so paranoid about losing any votes to Nader, especially in the Pacific Northwest. And if they can sway people into thinking that Gore is closer to winning than he really is, then they think they'll get those Nader votes away out of panic.
No, that, but Nader, just about 20 minutes before I went on the air, conceded the election before all of the votes were through across the nation, which means he was telling all of his followers to go vote for Gore.
You think so?
Absolutely. Why would he concede before all the polls are closed?
Well, just because he knew he was never going to win.
Bullshit! The only reason a candidate would concede the election before all the votes or all the polls are closed is if he wants to send a message to the people who would normally vote for him to vote for somebody else.
That's interesting.
That's very interesting, huh?
Now, let me ask you this, Bill. you know, a la vote scam, when everything was so completely rigged in those South Florida elections, the story in the Collier's book, if this is rigged, then why are they not able to rig those numbers to follow that electoral count they want us to believe?
Well, I don't know. Maybe they have caught on to the fact that most Americans really are not dealing with a full deck. And maybe they've caught on to the fact that they can tell the American people the truth about the real vote numbers and then lie to them about the Electoral College, something that Americans don't understand at all, and totally confuse them so much because they've never read the Constitution and don't know how the whole thing works, to get them to believe that one candidate can be elected to the White House even though that candidate really didn't win anything. And Americans will buy it. And I'm telling you right now, they're absolutely on the right track because most Americans are exactly in that kind of a mental breakdown.
You know, we also noticed earlier, too, that when 0% of the vote was in, New York was given to Hillary.
Yeah!
About 1% was in. They said she was ahead by 73%.
Yeah.
And then that has turned out to be very, very close.
Yeah. Well, I'm telling you, Lazio's going to win that Senate race in the state of New York.
Man.
With no vote count whatsoever, they announced Hillary was the clear winner.
Right.
And right now you're seeing that's not true. It's very close.
Well, let's say our prayers.
They also said in the beginning that Hillary got 58% of the Jewish vote.
Uh-huh.
How do they know that if none of the votes were even counted?
Very good.
Where did they get those figures?
Right.
This is bullshit. These are lies. This is Hermann Göring under Hitler propagandizing the American people, just like he did in Nazi Germany during the 30s.
I completely agree with you. Right on, Bill.
And remember, Hitler was a socialist. Al Gore is a socialist. Most of the major media are socialists.
Well, all I can say is...
Nazi means National Socialist German Workers' Party. They don't want you to know that, though.
Party candidate who's going to be in there, so I hope it's going to be Bush, and I hope he gives us some pleasant surprises. That's all I can say.
Well, the only reason I would hope that it would be Bush is that we have more time.
And so it will not be Gore.
If it's Gore, we'll be pushed into a civil war within the next 4 years.
Well,
if it's Bush, even if he gets reelected, we won't see a civil war until after 8 years are over.
Everybody turn on their VCR and flip around all these cable news channels and record these numbers.
Oh, this is the most incredible thing I've ever seen.
It really is. It's very exciting to watch this and very interesting.
Yes, it is. It's also keep
up the good work.
It's also very scary.
All right. You're right, it is.
Thanks for calling.
All right. Bye.
520-333-4578 is the number. Taking your calls for the rest of the hour. This is the most incredible thing I've ever seen in my life. It's in our faces. It's in our faces. They are lying to us right there in front of us and showing the two true numbers at the bottom of the screen, and nobody's catching on. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill.
Yeah.
I have the shortwave radio, and I take it in to work, and I turn it on when you're on, and now I have all my other coworkers listening to you on shortwave.
Well, great. That's wonderful.
And they all are going out to Radio Shack and the rest of them to buy shortwaves. I mean, this is great.
Good.
Because
they won't hear this kind of truth anywhere else.
No. That's what they've said, too. They've never heard anything like that before.
No, they won't.
No. And I said, if William Cooper says it, you can pretty much take it to the bank. You know. And,
well, you know what I always say. If you can prove me wrong, send me the proof, and I'll correct myself on the air.
Yeah.
And I don't want you to believe anything I say. I want you to listen to everybody, read everything, believe absolutely nothing, including from me, unless you can prove it in your own research. I've never lied to anybody. I've made some mistakes. And whenever I do, I always correct them. But I've never, ever lied to anyone. Ever.
Hey, yeah. Well, listen.
Except when I was a child.
I really love you like a brother.
Well,
I hold you up in prayer.
Thank you.
And I want you to know that this whole deal with this election is a big sham they're putting on and propaganda. I mean,
no kidding.
Goebbels would be proud.
Yep.
As to what they're doing today.
Yep.
This is terrible.
Oh, wait a minute. Earlier, what did I say? Hermann Göring? It's Joseph Goebbels. You see,
Joseph
that's a mistake.
Goebbels.
I made that mistake tonight.
Yeah.
I was calling Joseph Goebbels Hermann Göring. Göring was the head of the
Luftwaffe.
Yeah. And,
Reichsmarschall.
See, I make mistakes from time to time, but I never lie to anybody. And as soon as I catch on to my mistake, I correct. It's Joseph Goebbels, who was Hitler's propaganda minister.
Yeah. And
thank you for that, by the way.
We have a lot of propaganda to go wade through. It's like so much BS. You know, I mean, we have to deal with it.
Yeah.
And so much of this crap is going on. It is unreal. And
no, it's not unreal. It's real.
Yeah.
You're getting better.
Real.
It's real.
It's happening
right in front of our nose. And most people, if they're not tuned into this, if they don't even believe in the possibility that they could be lied to on television by these major networks, aren't even looking for it. They can see the numbers that are the truth at the bottom of the screen telling you the election results according to percent of the votes that are in, and listen to these guys say exactly the opposite, and they'll believe what these guys are saying rather than the actual polling results that are showing on their screen.
Oh, definitely. Definitely.
Well, that doesn't say much for Americans, does it?
No. The sheeple are believing all the things they see in smoke and mirrors.
Yep.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
You know, but I think if...
The very second the polls closed in New York, they announced Hillary Clinton was the clear winner, and no votes had even been counted. None. Period.
Yeah.
They even went so far as to say that 58% of the Jewish vote had gone for Hillary Clinton, and none of the votes had even been counted. Period.
Well, how do they know? Did they ask people?
They don't know. It's a lie. It's a at the polls. I don't know how they would know who's Jewish and who's black and whatever, unless somebody's sitting there, you know, asking them what their race is. But I can tell you this: whenever somebody asks me that, I tell them it's none of your business unless you're a racist, and I decline to answer. And I think a lot of people do that today because just asking that question is racist.
Oh, definitely. I mean, if I get out of a poll and they ask me, well, what are you? I mean, well.
That's none of your business.
Yeah.
I'm an American.
I know.
You know, what are you trying to do? Pit races against each other? That's the only purpose for asking a question like this.
Oh,
they should
yeah.
be concerned with the thoughts and and the opinions of Americans, not black Americans versus white Americans versus Hispanic Americans versus Jewish Americans. That's how they keep this conflict going between the races. And
the whole purpose of the left wing is to divide and conquer.
Absolutely, that's one of Marx's great tenets for winning the class war. I mean, without a class war, without racial contention, Marx hasn't got a chance. Thanks for calling.
Oh, yeah. God bless.
520-333-4578 is the number. Yeah, that was the whole premise of Karl Marx, is that there's a war between the races and there's a war between the classes. And so even if this war doesn't exist, they have to foment this war for socialism, for Marxism, to be able to stand on the battlefield and have a chance at winning. Good evening. You're on the air.
Good evening, Bill. Well, Bush is up by 6% according to a local NBC channel in Wisconsin, and they also show that, that's with 61% of the vote in, this local station also shows that he has a 1% lead in Wisconsin.
Well, how about Florida?
Oh, I said in Florida it was 6%.
I thought you said Wisconsin.
No, the local station, NBC station in Wisconsin, not CNBC, but a local NBC, shows Bush leading by 6% in Florida with 61% of the vote in.
Yeah.
And with...
He's going to take Florida.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
And he's up in Wisconsin, too, although not by a large margin.
He's also going to take Missouri. And he may take Michigan.
Well, they've tried to cook the books tonight. Let's see how long they think they can get away with it.
Well, they sure have. And it's just incredible. I sat there just absolutely... scandalized that they would have the guts to show the truth in the numbers at the bottom of the screen. In the meantime, lying out their mouth and blatantly giving the electoral votes of these states to Al Gore when he hasn't even won those states. And the numbers at the bottom of the screen clearly show that Bush is winning.
Well, they're simply churning.
And I'm not for Bush. Don't anybody get me wrong. I'm not for Bush. I am for the truth. And these people are liars.
Well, they're simply trying to harvest the fruits of the new math and the public school system. That's all.
Well, I'll tell you what. Within 4 years at the least, and within 12 years at the most, they may find themselves hanging from a lamppost.
Well, that's a good...
Because nobody's going to forget this crap. Nobody's going to forget their faces. Nobody's going to forget their names. I mean, it's just right there on the screen. We know who they are.
Well, I suggest we start out with these news anchors, and on that same day, we also say...
They've sold their souls. They
no
have
more,
sold...
No more electronic voting, paper ballots only... Counted locally and counting watched by local independent citizens groups.
Better count it several times by several different groups.
That's
make
right.
sure that the numbers always come out the same.
and no announcement of election results until midnight after closing of polls.
Yeah, this is absolutely
minimum.
I had never seen anything like this in my whole life. Thanks for calling.
Got to let you go.
520-333-4578. Isn't this incredible, folks? How in the world do they, even in their wildest dreams, think they're going to get away with this crap? Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill. In New York, on one of the local stations, a few minutes before your broadcast, about 5 minutes to 10 local time here, they were announcing that on Long Island, many of the polls were still jammed with people that got in before 9 o'clock, but hadn't even voted yet by 10 o'clock because they were so full. The turnout was so heavy.
Yeah.
How they can claim that Hillary is now the new senator, these people hadn't even gotten to their machine yet.
Yeah. Yeah. And plus, they haven't even counted absentee ballots at all. I mean, and at the time they announced that Hillary was the clear winner, not one vote had been counted. They didn't even have any numbers. And then they had the audacity to say on top of that 58% of the Jewish people in New York had voted for Hillary. And they had no numbers, no statistics, no nothing. This is the most vicious, in-your-face, lie, propaganda, scam-the-public attempt that I've ever seen in my life.
I'm just curious to see what's going to happen tomorrow, how many people are going to see what the actual results are as opposed to what the press is. I can't believe that the press is ready to eat that much crow.
I don't think they're ready to eat any crow at all. You see, if they say it, the majority of the American people will believe it. And if the results change tomorrow, they just won't report it. They will ignore it. And whoever they say is the president will be the president. Don't you understand how that works? What did Hitler say? If you say a lie often enough, everybody will believe it. And the bigger the lie, the more readily they will believe it.
Oh, I'm going to let you go. Have a good evening, Bill.
You too. This sucks. I'm not kidding you, folks. This sucks. In the United States of America. Can you believe this? We're getting bombarded by Joseph Goebbels. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill. Helix from Detroit.
Hi.
Like a lot of people don't realize either, too, that subliminal suggestion works on the subconscious.
Yeah.
In other words, on the conscious mind, you can accept, reject, or modify a thought. Whatever you receive, you either accept it, reject it, or modify it. But when it works on the subconscious level, you don't have that. You don't have that logic. You can't filter that.
No.
You automatically accept it.
That's right. That's why subliminal advertising and subliminal education and brainwashing and so on and so forth is so effective.
Yes, absolutely. Okay, I just wanted to make that comment and give a shout-out to all my beloved militia and to let our people know that we're not a sewing circle and we're geared up and ready.
Yeah. Clean your weapons. Be ready.
Yes, sir. Absolutely. Thank you.
Be ready.
Yes.
And make sure that you're right with God, because
absolutely.
You're
that's
have
the main thing.
That's
yes.
Right.
That's the main shot. Absolutely. Thank you.
Thank you for calling. Remember, they don't believe in God. So we've got an edge right there. 520-333-4578 is the number. Good evening. You're on the air. Hello.
Hello. Is this Bill?
Well, if you called Al, you got the wrong number. Of course this is Bill.
Absolutely
not. You called my number, didn't you? Who did you think was going to answer the phone if you called my number?
I wasn't absolutely sure.
No, you weren't. Well,
anyway, I've been dialing and dialing. I'm up here in Macomb, Michigan.
Well, you got me. What's up?
Up here in Michigan, they've been showing Bush ahead here by about 10 points with the popular vote since they even started counting the vote.
Yeah, I know.
1% of the vote, and I think the polls weren't even closed here, and they gave the state to Al.
Yep, that's right. And we heard this
to top it off, about an hour later than that, they decided, somewhere, I should say right before 8 o'clock, they decided in Detroit, they went to the federal courthouse, the Democrats, to try and keep the polls open until 10 o'clock.
They did the same thing as St. Louis, and the judge ruled against them.
I think it's pretty obnoxious.
Not only is it obnoxious, it's insulting, it's sickening. It's communistic. It's the things that happen in third world countries or the Soviet Union or Castro's Cuba. And I'm telling you what, one of these days, they're going to piss us off so much that we're going to take our guns that our founding fathers gave us, we're going to stick them up their butts, and we're going to have to pull the trigger.
Amen.
And that's the truth. I mean, who in the hell do these people think they are that they can pull this? There's things I want to say that I can't say on radio. They pull this crap on the American people, who all we want to do is live in freedom under the rule of law, and the only real rule of law is the Constitution for the United States of America, which restricts the federal government, and live in peace and harmony with our neighbors and with the rest of the world. And these people are just creating the scenario where we're going to have to take up arms and kill people in order to reinstate constitutional Republican government. And that just makes me absolutely sick. I fought a war once. I don't want to have to fight another one. But if they force me to do it, I will not hesitate to do it. And I won't hesitate to kill every one of them I see. I just won't even have a conscience about it.
I don't think there's going to be any other way to do it either.
Well, there isn't. If you think there's going to be a political solution, you're out of your rabbit-ass mind. I mean, it's just not going to happen, period. We're so far beyond that point, it's pathetic. And all of these politicians in Washington, D.C. don't give a rat's ass about any of us. They don't even listen to us anymore. NAFTA should have told you that. Gosh, the opinion of the American people and the telegrams and the letters and the email and the phone calls were 1,000 to 1 against NAFTA, and they still passed that crap and sent our industry fleeing from our shores.
Well, I still say Bush is going to get the popular vote no matter what here.
Well, absolutely, without a doubt.
I don't know what they think they're doing with the.
And he's going to win. He's going to win the He's going to win the electoral vote also, if they really count the real votes and go through with the real thing. But if they propagandize the American people, and the American people believe the propaganda, then Gore's going to go in the White House. And if that happens, the day that it happens, when all of this stuff has occurred, is the day I'm going to pick up a rifle, I'm going to come down off this mountain, and I'm going to go to war with the federal government.
I hear you.
And anybody that wants to accompany me is welcome. If you don't, I'll be glad to die for my country all by myself for the right cause. We must reinstate constitutional Republican government. I'm telling you right now, there's no other way than with the force of arms. And if Gore gets in that White House, on top of all of this phony election bullshit, then anybody who refuses to pick up arms and reinstate constitutional Republican government at that point is going to get what they deserve. And what we're going to get is a Soviet-type government and a gulag archipelago right here in the United States of America.
I think that day is coming soon here.
Yeah, it's coming very soon. If Gore gets in the White House, you can believe
it. I'm going to get off and let you go so you can at least get another call in here.
Well, we're out of time. Thanks for calling.
Okay, thank you.
Good night, folks. God bless each and every single one of you. Go watch this stuff. Get an education. Understand what's coming down. And be ready. Clean your weapons. Make sure you have a Bible. Make sure you're right with God. Make sure you've got plenty of food and water and clothing to be able to fight a war for at least 10 to 15 years, because that may be what it takes. Good night, Annie Poon Allison. I love you. All my heart and soul. And that you can also take to the bank.
All of a sudden, in the middle of the night, there's a loud knock on your door. Hey, honey. Something's not right.
Throw out your arms. Let this deadlock pass through. We're here for the government. We're here to help you.
And I'm from the IRS with a power to tax. If you've got a complaint, send us a fax.
Get out of this house. Serve your taxes. Give me your gold. You never made it you want to come home. Get to this stuff and give me your gold.
Hillary Salala, Reno Janet Dyke, reading the words of General Albert Pike, demonic founder of the Ku Klux Klan, engineer of the Masonic Master Plan. Pike said Lucifer is God across the land, and put the same take the mark in your right hand. While we're all dancing to the drums of uproar's right, Clinton's preparing it for another huge attack. Hike. Order out of chaos, depression, inflation, creates a panic and rapes the nation. Crisis creation. Incite black and white, program agitation.
Don't resist! You're surrounded by the UN in white and blue, the ATF, the men in black, from the One World Order.
But it's not new. Iron Mountain, computer beasts, and cattle mutilations. Black projects, UFOs, and weird genetic combinations. The Nazi doctors didn't die. Come on, get him. They came here with the OSS through Operation Paperclip. National ID? Debit cards? Yeah. Vaccination biochip, milk carton kits, genetic engineering. Clinton says her health plans for you and your own good. Sure. And Adolf Hitler's Robin Hood. Masonic mind manipulation. Inciting riots is crisis creation. Biochip implantation. Vaccinate your kid for UN identification.
This is a test for all of us. So I have today just one simple request.
a comprehensive package of health care benefits that are always there and can never be taken away.
Atmospheric, social illusion, media hype, plan confusion,
Masonic religion, it's a liar. Got your brain for a Luciferian Messiah.
International government gangsters took it from the greatest creditor nation to the largest debtor nation on earth. Our standard of living has dropped like a rock for 4 out of every 5 Americans. They have foreclosed on our homes, our farms, our factories. They've exported your jobs and surrendered our arms.
They want it.
A new world order. A new world order.
You to be a slave from birth to grave. The banksters own the Federal Reserve. It's private. They own it. It's neither federal nor a reserve. The cashists make that fiat funny money stuff you call dollars for 2 pennies. They lend it back to us at full face value, then charge you interest. You get the debt. They get the interest. They get the gold. You get the cash.
They want it.
A new world order.
Good evening, folks. You're listening to the Hour of the Time. I'm William Cooper. And, by golly, pretty interesting stuff going on. It's cold here. I mean, it's really cold here. Really cold, cold. I got every heater in the house on. I got a fire in the fireplace. And yep, for all you environmentalists, yes, I'm really burning trees. I got the oven door open and I got the oven on because it's cold. I mean, it's really cold. It's been snowing all day long. Temperatures below freezing. How far below freezing, I don't know, but it's enough, it's far enough below freezing that when I go outside, my fingers are brittle and feel like they're going to break off within about 5 minutes. And, you know, my breath, I say a word and it freezes solid and you can read it in the air and it falls to the ground and breaks into a million pieces. You shine a light on it, looks like a neon sign, you know. It says, it's cold. Really cold. And it's going to snow probably all night. And that's going on in other parts of the country, too. Pretty bad weather. So that means in some parts of the country, the turnout for voting is not going to be too good. But overall, I think we may see some record turnouts here, especially on the Republican side. Don't pay any attention to any of these polls. None of them. And if you've been to our website, you know why already. You already know why. If you've been to the website and read my editorial there, are my exclusive story, then you know why. Don't you think it's strange that up until tonight, no Pole has had the guts to show Gore ahead at all? And that's because he's really way behind. And the reason I know this, it's on the website if you'll read the article, but polls are not used to sample the opinion of Americans. They're used to determine American opinion, used to determine actions of people. But they can't put out polls that would discredit the polling process. There's nobody in this country who's really watching what's happening that would believe it if the polls were to say that Al Gore is ahead. And so there was a last-ditch effort tonight by the Zogby poll to attempt to make people think that Gore's ahead in order to get people who maybe aren't decided yet to vote for Gore to be on the winning side. Truth is, Gore's not ahead. Gore has never been ahead in this race. He's not going to be ahead in this race, and tomorrow George Walker Bush is going to win the popular vote. Now, that doesn't mean that he's going to zip into the White House, regardless of what I wrote in that article on the website. I wrote that predicated on the fact that the popular vote is going to be reflected in the electoral vote, and that there's not going to be any vote fraud. If all those things are true, George Bush will be sitting in the Oval Office come January the 21st. But there's already vote fraud going on. There's vote fraud already occurring in the state of Illinois. There's vote fraud already occurring in the state of California. There's vote fraud already occurring in the state of Arkansas, where people have already voted for the president. And I'm not saying this off the top of my head. The governor of the state of Arkansas said that on the Don Imus radio broadcast this morning. That's right, folks. He was a guest on Don Imus, and he said that in the state of Arkansas, many people are picked up by buses right after they get out of church on Sunday morning, and they're taken to the polls where they cast their vote for president, and those votes are not even supposed to be cast until Tuesday. In the state of Illinois, the Democratic Party has a habit every presidential election of actually raising the dead. And I guarantee you that's happening in Illinois today. It's happening in Arkansas, too. Those two states are probably the worst. But it happens, you know, all over the country where they can get away with it. And the Democrat Party is the worst at making this vote fraud happen. It's called the machine. The Democrat machine. In the state of California, illegal immigrants have been getting letters from the Democrat Party with a little card telling them that even though they haven't registered to vote, they've been registered to vote, congratulating them on registering to vote, telling them to sign this card, present it at the polling place where they are told to go in the letter that they're registered as a Democrat and to cast their vote for Al Gore. This is already happening in the state of California. Now, if you want to read the story, it's an exclusive on WorldNet Daily. You know, I don't like to admit that other people have exclusives other than us, but, you know, Joseph Farah did a good job on this. So if you go to WorldNet Daily on the Internet and read that story, and you can get there by going to williamcooper.com, clicking on the story. It'll take you right there. You can read it, and it's the truth. And I used to live in California. I have a lot of friends there. We've checked it out. It's true. That's what's happening all over the state of California. Illegal immigrants are getting letters from the Democrat machine telling them that they've congratulating them for registering to vote. It contains a letter and a card instructing them what to do. It tells them to sign the card, take it to a specific polling place where they will be conducted to the voting booth, and they will vote for Al Gore. The state of Arkansas, well, what can I say? It's Bill Clinton's state, isn't it? And people have already voted for president today, right after they got out of church. Think I'm crazy? Hey, this came straight from the mouth of the governor of Arkansas, who is very concerned about crooked vote fraud in his own state. And he admitted it. He said that this is happening in Arkansas. He said the dead is coming up out of the cemeteries and voting in Arkansas. He's concerned about it. But he said, here's what he said. He said, when the precincts are controlled by the Democrat Party, and the district attorneys are Democrats, and the judges are Democrats, and the pastors in the churches and the mayors of the towns are all Democrats, what can I do about it? Well, I don't know, but I'll tell you what, if I was the governor, I'd call up the National Guard. I'd put all those people in protective custody, and I'd put the National Guard in charge of the voting polls, and I'd make sure that the polls, voting process was conducted properly. But apparently, in Arkansas, either there's no National Guard, or he doesn't know what kind of powers he has, or he's just not willing to do it. He also said that the ballots were taken from many of the polling places to prominent Democrat homes for safekeeping. This is what the governor of the state of Arkansas said on the Don Imus radio show this morning. So, I got to tell you, folks, all bets are off when this kind of stuff is going on. And but I got to tell you something else, too. You know, the final vote count is conducted on government computers that are controlled by the military, and the military hates the Democrat Party after all that's been happening in the last 8 years. So they might make sure that Bush wins. If everything is conducted fair and square and on the up and up, Bush will win the popular vote. Will he be president? Well, it depends on the Electoral College. And as I've told you in the past, and as they've been telling you for the last 2 or 3 weeks, on every television channel that you watch, the Electoral College could elect Al Gore, even though George Bush gets the majority of the popular vote. And as I have told you on this broadcast, and as they've been telling you in the last 3 weeks, on every television channel on television, they've been telling you the truth, the Electoral College does not have to reflect the popular vote in their state. They don't have to vote for who their state says they have to vote for. And that's the truth. They can vote for anybody they want to. You see, the state has no jurisdiction over a federal election. Doesn't matter what the state law is. And even if the state has a law that says that the elector goes against the vote of the state or the people that he's supposed to represent in that state, if he goes against their popular vote, they can throw him in jail. How long do you think he's going to be in jail because he voted his conscience, according to the Constitution and federal law? And by the way, I know the Constitution backward and forward, and I know all the amendments to the Constitution. There is nothing in the Constitution, and there is no amendment to the Constitution which says an elector has to do what the people in the state vote for. Anywhere. And that's the truth. The only jurisdiction over federal elections is federal jurisdiction. State has no jurisdiction whatsoever, except the jurisdiction the Constitution allows the state to have, which is this, that the state can appoint the electors, and the state can determine how they're going to be appointed, but the state cannot tell them how to vote. Period. End of subject. You can argue about it till you're purple in the face. You're all full of crap. If you don't believe it, read the Constitution. Read all the amendments to the Constitution. Read federal law. It doesn't matter if your state says that the elector must cast his vote in the Electoral College according to the way the people in the state vote. The state has no jurisdiction to demand that an elector do that. And an appeal to the Supreme Court will result in every instance in an overturning of that law. And even if there is no appeal and it doesn't go to the Supreme Court and the guy decides to vote his conscience, you know, whether he's going to be prosecuted and go to jail or not, it won't change the presidential election. They won't reverse his vote, nor will they not count it, no matter what the state says. And if the state puts him in jail, how long do you think he'll be in jail because he did what he felt he was supposed to do under federal law? What? 3 months? 4 months? Let's say the state is really severe in their punishment and they give him 6 months. Oh, big deal. If you really were an elector and you really believe that you couldn't vote for who the people cast their majority vote for, and you voted for the other guy because you thought it was in the best interest of the country, which, by the way, was the whole idea behind the founding fathers creating the Electoral College in the first place, was to make sure that the mob didn't put somebody in the White House that didn't really belong there. You see, this is not a democracy, never was intended to be, and if you read the Constitution, the people do not elect the president and are not supposed to elect the president. And if the popular vote is for somebody that the Electoral College knows is not good for the country, these are supposed to be statesmen, they're free to put anybody that they want in there. My dear listeners, and that might just be what happens. What do you think would happen if George Bush wins the popular vote, which I guarantee you he will, and Al Gore gets elected by the Electoral College? I'm telling you, there's going to be some hot tempers and probably some violence across this country. And for the first time in the history of this country, there would be a Jewish vice president. Boy, wouldn't the state of Israel love that? What do you think the Mossad would feel like doing? The Mossad might want to bump off Al Gore so that Joseph Lieberman could just hop right into that seat. And I got to tell you that with our power and military might and nuclear arsenal, the Mideast crisis could be solved in 12 days. Maybe not properly solved, but it could be solved in 12 days. Would all this happen? Hell, I don't know. But I do know there's a lot of people who would want it to happen. Guaranteed. But even if that scenario didn't play out, I got to tell you, George Bush is not good for this country. Pat Buchanan is absolutely not good for this country. Ralph Nader is so far left-wing, communist, pinko, socialist, weird. He's not good for this country. But out of all of them, the very worst person that could ever be in that White House is Al Gore. Is Al Gore. So everybody listening, you should go out and vote tomorrow. You should vote for whoever you want to vote for, but I'm going to plead with you tonight. Like Don Imus says, I'm begging you, people. You got to vote for this guy. He's talking about, I'm begging you, people. You got to vote for this guy. He's talking about George Bush. And Don Imus is not a Republican. He doesn't even like George Bush. But he hates Al Gore. And he hates Al Gore because Al Gore is the biggest phony, lying, wishy-washy, socialist, dangerous, pinko, Christian-hating person on the face of this earth. And you better understand that. If you think Bill Clinton was bad, if Al Gore gets in the White House, America as we have known it in our lifetimes, as anybody living has ever known it, is finished, done, kaput. You'll never see it again. And if that happens, freedom is gone forever. Forever and ever. I'm not telling you not to vote for it. I can't do that. You have a right to vote for whoever you wish to put in that Oval Office, knowing full well that your vote doesn't mean a damn thing. The Electoral College is going to put in there who they want to be in there, not who you have elected. And in this race, they have been touting it as being so close that that could be the whole purpose, is to override the popular vote and make sure that Al Gore gets in that White House. And I'm telling you right now, it's not that close. Never was. If it was, then all the polls would be showing Gore ahead, and they would have been showing Gore ahead all along. Instead of the night before the election, only one poll showing Gore ahead, and that's a Zogby poll, and Zogby is a Gore supporter. All the other polls don't dare do it because they know their polls will be discredited. Because it's just not true. You can't trust the polls anyway because these polls are done by telephone random sampling in areas according to demographics that say if you call this area, you get a Republican. If you call this area, you'll get a Democrat. And they're supposed to be sampling both of these. In other words, no poll is supposed to be sampling just Republicans or just Democrats. It's supposed to be even. And independents and, you know, Green Party and all of this other stuff. That's how polls are supposed to be done. And if you're sampling correctly, then you have a plus or minus, you know, percentage of what they call error or possible error, which doesn't mean anything because even that's not absolute. But a good percentage of the people that they call aren't even going to vote in the first place. And that's one of the things that makes all these polls just absolute baloney. There is a certain percentage of people who will lie just to screw up the polls intentionally. And there's a certain percentage of people who will lie anyway because somebody in their family is listening and they don't want them to know how they're really going to vote when they get to the poll. And none of these polls take any of that stuff into consideration. But the real reason not to believe the polls, we did some research on who owns and controls the polling process in this country. And over 90% of the people who own and control the polls or the polling process are left-wing liberal socialists. Now, the next question you're going to ask is, well, how come they all show Bush ahead? Well, I'm going to tell you, folks, because he really is ahead. And the best they can do is try to show a close margin. And the reason they do that is to make the Democrat Party work harder to get out the vote. It's also making the Republicans work harder to get out the vote, but the Democrats are the ones that need it the most. You see, if Al Gore was really ahead, they wouldn't show him even. They wouldn't show the race close. They would show him way ahead. And this would encourage undecided voters to vote for Gore so that they would be voting for the winner. Because Americans don't like to be on the losing side. It's ingrained in us from the time we're born. It's ingrained in us throughout school. It's ingrained in us every time we watch a football game. Did you ever see the crowd come out of the stands and carry the losing team off the field on their shoulders? Never. You never will. You ever seen a celebration in the losing locker room? Never. And you never will. That's why people refrain from voting until the last minute so they can go down and vote for the winner. So they can say, oh, I voted for that guy. He's the president. I'm not a loser. They missed the whole point of the whole thing. But most of all, they're deluded into thinking that their vote really means something in the first place when it really doesn't. It's the Electoral College that elects the president, and they can vote for whomever they want. But the process is pretty well controlled so that the candidates that you have to choose from that actually have a chance of winning at all are both on the side of the people who want to put the president in the White House. So it really doesn't matter. Unless there's some overwhelming reason why one should get it over the other. And in this instance, there is. At no time in the history of the race toward the New World Order has anyone made as many strides toward the destruction of this country and the bringing about of world government than the Democrat Party has in the last 8 years with Bill Clinton and Al Gore in the White House. And they know that the Republican Party will slow this process down. The Republican Party will eventually lead us to the same point in the future where there's one world government, one world totalitarian socialist government. Bet your ass on it. But they won't do it as fast as the Democrat Party will because they are afraid of a civil war. And the Democrat Party doesn't believe that there's going to be a civil war. And I'm telling you right now, you put Al Gore in the White House, there'll be a civil war will start in the next 4 years in this country. You put Bush in the White House, it may not start for another 8 or 12 years. But there will be a civil war in this country. And it doesn't matter whether it's the Democrat Party or the Republican Party in the White House. They are all bent on the destruction of the United States of America, the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, and the formation of what they call a New World Order. A one-world totalitarian socialist government. It's coming. It's coming. And the only thing that's going to stop it is American people who own guns. Don't buy all this baloney about George Walker Bush getting in the White House and preserving the right to keep and bear arms. He will compromise on gun control bills that will come out of Congress, and the move toward the eventual confiscation of the guns in the hands of the American people will continue, just as it always has. Remember, his father said the same thing. And some pretty strict anti-gun legislation was passed during the Bush presidency. Some was even passed during the Reagan presidency, in case you don't remember. So, begging you people, you got to vote for that man. Begging you people, you got to vote for this guy. Ah! I mean, you see that four times an hour on MSNBC. Don Imus making that statement. By the way, MSNBC is knocking CNN off as the top rating news network. Why? Well, MSNBC has become an exciting channel, an exciting network. And CNN just plugs along like it always has, boring, 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 boring. And, of course, people are going to be attracted to the excitement, wherever the excitement is. And unless CNN turns that around, MSNBC is kicking their butt. Doesn't mean that MSNBC is telling the truth or that's where you ought to be watching or anything like that. I'm just telling you, they're taking ratings away from CNN. In fact, they've already knocked Larry King off as the top number one program in news. He's no longer the king. It's MSNBC. So those are just things to think about, folks. At 4 o'clock in the morning here, voting will begin on the East Coast, where it will be 6 a.m., And when the polls close here, there will still be 1 hour left to vote in the state of California. By the way, in the state of California, there are still 3.5 million absentee ballots that have not come in yet. And so That's 58 electoral votes that no one is going to know how that vote is going to go, maybe for, might be for another whole week. But I guarantee it's not going to be on Tuesday because there's 3.5 million votes they can't count yet. They're absentee ballots that haven't come back. In fact, a lot of them haven't even gone out yet to the people that have requested them. In the military, has made a statement that they ran out of absentee ballots and they need a whole bunch of more absentee ballots to give to their personnel in foreign countries that want to vote that don't have absentee ballots to be able to vote. So that may hold up some of the vote count. Whether it will or not, nobody really knows. They might go ahead and count the votes and say they counted them all when they really didn't. And whatever. We've been through this before many times, and we know that a lot of things can happen, a lot of strange things. I'm predicting that George Bush will win the popular vote, and if everything goes on the up and up, clean and straight, like it's supposed to, he will be the next president of the United States of America. I'm also predicting that Rick Lazio will beat Hillary Clinton in the state of New York, simply because unless the Jewish people have lost their minds, unless they're willing to vote for somebody who supported Arab, Muslim, and Palestinian terrorist organizations for her entire adult life, then Rick Lazio is going to beat Hillary Clinton. If the Jewish people have lost their minds, then Hillary Clinton is going to win that election. If they've lost their minds, then if she gets in the United States Senate and has any power, and I got to tell you this, if George Bush wins the presidency and goes into the White House and Hillary Clinton wins the Senate race for the state of New York and goes in the Senate, Hillary Clinton is going to run for the office of president in the next presidential election. Well, that's something to think about, isn't it? She will, if she wins that election, automatically be heaped with recognition and power that she really doesn't have. People, they're just going to give her power. And you watch. If she's elected in the state of New York to the United States Senate, when she walks onto the Senate floor for the first time, the entire Senate will stand up and applaud her. Why? Folks, I haven't got the faintest idea, but I know, just like I know the sun is going to rise tomorrow morning, that that's exactly what's going to happen. And they're going to give her power that she doesn't deserve, is not due, and will certainly misuse. And if the Jewish people put her there, they're going to be sorry. Because she's not on their side. She's a liar, just like her husband. She'll do anything for power, just like her husband. And for her entire life, ever since her college days, she has supported with her efforts, with her voice, and with her money, Arab, Muslim, and Palestinian terrorist causes. Now, I'm not saying the Palestinians are wrong. I'm not saying the Arabs are wrong. I'm not saying the Muslims are wrong. I'm making a statement about the Jewish people voting for Hillary Clinton. And it's a true statement. And anybody who's ever researched her life, the causes that she supported, the causes to which she has donated money, the causes from which she has accepted money, you also know that it's true. Ain't that a proverbial bitch? Not Hillary, you understand. The statement. The state of affairs. The facts of the matter. What we used to call, ain't that a bitch?
Never in human history has so few taken so much from so many as America's Illuminati and their warlords of Wall Street and Washington. In just 8 years, these banksters and international government gangsters took us from the greatest creditor nation to the largest debtor nation on Earth. Our standard of living has dropped like a rock for 4 out of every 5 Americans.
By the way, if you're listening on shortwave in the Round Valley or in the state of Arizona, 101.1 FM is off the air. We've suffered a casualty in some of our equipment. I haven't been able to find the cause of it yet. But we can't get out. I mean, it's not, it's broadcasting somewhere, but, you know, only within about 50 yards of the studio. So, if you're in the Round Valley and you're forced to listen on shortwave because you can't get 101.1 FM, that's why. It's off the air. We've suffered some kind of an equipment breakdown, and I can't figure out what it is yet, but I'm working feverishly to solve the problem.
It's private. They own it. It's neither federal nor a reserve. The cashes make that fiat funny money stuff you call dollars for 2 pennies. They lend it back to us at full face value. Then charge you interest, you get the debt. They get the interest. They get the gold. You
can open the phones, take your calls for the rest of the hour. 520-333-4578. I want to hear your views on the election. Who are you going to vote for and why? And, you know, how, what do you think the outcome's going to be? Because I could be wrong on this whole thing. I hope I'm, you know, I hope I'm not. If Gore gets in the White House, we're in the Buffalo chip sector is where we're going to be. 520-333-4578 is the number.
Controls the CIA, the FBI, the ATF, and the FDA. They don't give a damn about the POW and the MIA. Hillary, Billary, Hitler.
Well, the phones are open, folks. 520-333-4578 is the number.
This Illuminati imports the dope they create.
Don't you think it's really strange? This is a nation of 50 sovereign states, supposedly. We all know that that's a joke, but supposedly it's 50 sovereign states, and here we are looking at a scenario where with what he's got, Al Gore could end up taking the popular vote in only 16 states, garner the electoral vote if they go along with it, and could be in the White House with a minority of the states having put him there. Good evening, you're on the air.
Oh, hi, Mr. Cobra. This is Virginia calling.
Hi.
I was listening to Frank and John on BCQ on Friday night and Saturday night.
Uh-huh.
And they were talking about, I don't know where they heard it or got it from, but they said that Hillary Clinton had ordered the Secret Service to confiscate the voting ballots when they're finished voting.
How are they going to get away with that?
I don't know.
The whole state of New York is going to be watching.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
And I got to tell you, out of all the states in this country, you got some really weird people in New York who are watching everything. And screaming at the top of their lungs if they see anything slightly out of the ordinary. It's not like Podunk, Michigan, where people are embarrassed to say something. You know, New York, she couldn't get away with that, neither could the Secret Service if they tried.
Well, I'm hoping. I tell you, it's getting to be a point of a toss-up here. I was hoping George Bush would get in. I've been thinking for quite a while that he will. But I'll tell you what, there's not a hotel room tonight in Austin anywhere to be had.
Well, I bet there's not.
No, they're planning a big celebration.
Yeah, I bet they are. I bet there's going to be a lot of people at the airport tonight to welcome him when he flies in after his campaign trip, and there'll be parties all night and all day tomorrow and probably all night tomorrow night, because I'm telling you right now, Bush has got the popular vote sewed up.
Yeah, I thought for a long time. I just hope the electoral college, is it, gets the same pew.
Well, let me tell you something. Nobody has ever been elected to the White House who lost the vote in his home state, and Al Gore hasn't got a prayer of carrying Tennessee.
Oh, yeah, I heard there's also a lot of hotel rooms available in Tennessee. Well, I'll be watching tomorrow, and I appreciate your program.
Now, that doesn't mean that's the way it's going to be this time, but I'm telling you, that's the way it's always been.
Oh, we're really up the creek of Algots, then.
Yeah, they also, and I've been hearing this on television, I don't know if it's true because I didn't check into it, but they've said that since 1950, no president has been elected that didn't carry Delaware and Missouri.
I'm still learning on how this works. I'm catching on.
But why should people even listen to that? What's 1950 to now compared to 1789 to 1950?
Just more baloney to confuse people. Just to confuse people.
Oh, it's pure bullshit.
Oh, by the way, I wanted to ask you, did you bring the chickens in?
No, the chickens are out there, just they're loving it.
Oh, are they?
Oh, yeah, chickens don't, you know, chickens are like sugar bear. Sugar bear has this big, thick, sugar bear is a Keesend, which is a Dutch barge dog. They live out in the elements,
oh,
in the
okay.
snow and the rain and stuff, and so Sugar Bear doesn't get cold and doesn't bother him a bit. He just fluffs up his fur and curls up, and, you know, he's nice and warm. He has this thick coat of fur, and underneath there's, like, down, you know.
Uh-huh.
And chickens, what they do is they fluff up their feathers, and they trap this air between all this their feathers, and they have this down between their feathers and their skin. And as long as they can fold their feet in and keep them in where it's warm, they don't get cold either.
Are they doing okay together?
They're doing fine.
Oh, great.
Yeah. And when it gets real cold, they just curl up with Sugar Bear.
That's great.
Those chickens really belong to Sugar Bear.
Yeah, I'm glad that he's, he's happy with his chickens.
He loves them. He's the only dog in the world's got his own chickens. And he loves them.
All right, talk to you later.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
And that was your suggestion.
Yeah, I know.
See what you started?
Bye-bye.
I'm begging you, folks. You got to vote for this guy. Thanks for calling. 520-333-4578 is the number. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Bill. This is Mike from Indiana.
Hi, Mike.
Oh, hi, Bill. How are you doing this evening?
Well, I'm enjoying this. You know, I enjoy the election thing because I can see through all the bullshit and I can see how people are getting scammed and I can read between the lines and all that kind of stuff. It's fun for me. Even though the outcome may be terrible for all of us, the process, to me, is intriguing, it's fun, it's sometimes it's hilarious, sometimes it makes me get tears in my eyes because I know how people are being fooled by all this crap, but it's exciting.
Yeah, I find it exciting too myself. I've been watching it like you since the beginning, but I think the one issue that I have to vote for, I have to vote for life. That's the way I feel about it. I feel that Bush gets in there, and maybe he'll pass the partial birth abortion ban. Probably this U.S. Supreme Court will ban it, but at least, you know, there's a shot for them, you know, at least a third trimester unborn. That's the way I look at it right now.
Well, you say it's not Bush who does it. It's the Congress who does it.
Right. Well, they would send a bill, obviously.
Yeah, if they pass it. But Congress hasn't. They didn't pass it last time, did they?
Right. Well, it was overridden after the veto.
Well, you're talking about partial birth.
Partial birth.
Yeah, that's correct.
Right, and, you know, hopefully this time they won't have to go through the through a veto and maybe all the votes this time, but you never know.
Yeah, but you know, that was a close vote. It almost didn't pass in the Congress. And if the Democrats get more seats this time, which they might do, there may never be another partial birth abortion ban bill that goes to the White House.
Yeah, absolutely. This is like probably the last election. I agree with you. There are so many socialists. It seems like they're growing by the numbers, you know.
And they all talk about the promise of America and how their ancestors came to America because this was the greatest country in the world, and here they are destroying it, trying to make it into something else, because
right.
The truth is, that's all bullshit rhetoric. They hate this country.
Right, exactly. They, you know, I talk to people, and I have to stop everybody in their path and tell them when they say, oh, it's a democracy. What I do is I make them say the Pledge of Allegiance. And when they get to the Republic, I say, stop right there. You know, because into the republic for which it stands,
yeah.
And then they think for a second. Well, what's a republic? And then you have to tell them. There's so many people that don't even know what kind of.
Well, you should also carry a copy of the Constitution. Then you can show them Article 4, Section 4, which guarantees us a republican form of government. And nowhere in the Constitution does it mention democracy anywhere, not once.
Absolutely. Hey, Bill, I'm going to tell you one more thing. I really appreciate you telling us to go up and look stuff. You know, for the first time, I looked up the Indiana State Constitution, and I found out that we have the right to keep and bear arms. And
yeah, you never knew that before, did you?
What's that? No, I never did.
Yeah,
and
in Indiana, aren't they trying to take your guns away from you?
Well, they...
Aren't there local governments to say that you can't own guns?
Well, actually, it's up here in the more liberal parts of the state.
Yeah, but aren't they doing that?
Unfortunately,
if
yeah.
your Constitution says you have the right to keep and bear arms, they can't do it, can they?
They cannot, and absolutely, the fact is that right could never be abolished.
That's
because
right.
Because it's so fundamental to...
Yeah, but see, nobody in the state of Indiana ever read their constitution, so nobody's challenging them in court, and so they get away with that bullshit, don't they?
Yeah, you're right.
Well, in Arizona, they can't get away with that bullshit.
Right, you know, I read the Arizona state constitution, I also read California, and there's no right like that in California.
Yeah.
But, hey, Bill, thank you.
Wait a minute. In California, guess what you have the right to do?
What's that?
You have the right to go fishing. That's in their constitution. That's in the Constitution for the state of California. You have the right to go fishing.
Well, you know, the conservationists are probably going to take that away. I mean, we can't hurt little fish now.
Oh, no, it's in the Constitution.
Oh, they might...
Can't stop you from going fishing in California. So, you know, if you have a tackle box and a whole bunch of hooks and flies,
right.
You know, if they come to get you, you can cast hooks at them and, you know, pull their ears off and stuff like that. You know, and if they get pissed, you say, "Hey, man, I'm just fishing. I can't help it if you're between me and the water."
Yeah.
You know?
You never believe what I got called to do last week, Bill.
What's that?
I actually worked for the Teamsters, and I got called actually to unload trucks for the Al Gore rally in Chicago.
Oh, really?
Really?
Oh, God, I would have quit. But you're a union. You couldn't quit.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, here's one union guy for that knows the truth, believe me. And I try to tell every person I can.
Good for you.
I'm pretty much hated, but I don't
Good care. For you, because Gore stands for socialism, and socialism does not allow unions once they take over everything.
Oh, absolutely. I told one guy, he told me who I have to vote for. I said, well, sorry, I'm breaking with the rank and file, and he just looked at me with seething.
Yeah.
But well, thank you, sir.
You know, they'll learn the hard way.
Thanks. Yeah, they sure will.
Thanks for calling.
Okay, Bob, have a good evening.
You too.
Bye-bye.
520-333-4578 is the number, and it's your turn, whoever you are. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Mr. Cooper. Charlie, New York.
Hi, Charlie.
I was wondering if you could answer a question for me.
Well, I might be able to. There's some questions I can answer, and some I can't, and some I wouldn't even deign to try.
But it's a constitutional question, so.
Go for it.
When do the delegates actually cast their vote?
You're talking about the
electoral.
The electoral. It's not the day of the election.
I know that.
I don't know the exact date, but it's after the popular election takes place. I think it's a ways away. As a matter of fact, it's not even close to the date that the popular election takes place.
I've been trying to find that out.
It's in the Constitution. The Constitution says it all. It's right there.
Okay, I know they make a maxim like...
Why do you guys always look other than the Constitution for what the Constitution mandates? That's where you got to go to start on everything.
I know the limit. The outside limit is March.
Go to the Constitution, right. And then go to the United States Code. And that's where you're going to find it all.
Okay. Alrighty, sir. I've been harassing the Assembly and State Senate and...
Harass them. Kick their butts. Get on them.
Oh, I have. Absolutely. And I appreciate everything you're doing, sir.
Thank you. Well, I appreciate what you're doing. I appreciate you asking those questions. But, you know, it really irks me when you guys don't go to the Constitution first. You've got to start there. If you don't start there and if you don't understand and know the Constitution, then what the hell are you doing? Everything else you're doing is moot. It's for nothing. It means nothing.
But there's no specific date other than an outside date.
Go back and look again. Even if there's an outside date, at least you know the parameters.
Right, okay.
Okay? You know, right. You know it's got to be done before a certain date, right?
Right, yeah,
okay.
Right.
Go for it. I don't know the exact date because I know what the Constitution says, but I don't know what the federal government has determined.
Okay.
Okay?
All right, thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome.
God bless you.
Thanks for calling.
Yes, sir.
520-333-4578 is the number. And actually, the date doesn't matter. They're going to meet, and they're going to cast their vote, and they're going to elect their president. And it's going to be the Electoral College that does it, not the popular vote, not the people. People, actually, if you want to know the truth, if you read the Constitution, if you read the amendments to the Constitution, if you read federal law, people have absolutely nothing to do with it. Nothing. Period. Now, there are some states that have tried to force the Electoral College, or at least their representatives to the Electoral College, to reflect the popular vote in that state. And they've even passed laws that say that if the elector does not vote according to the way the people voted, then he can go to jail. But nobody's ever challenged that to the Supreme Court, and I'm telling you, the first time they ever do, it'll be struck down, because states cannot dictate anything to do with federal elections. They can only follow what the Constitution allows them to do, and the only thing the Constitution allows the states to do is choose the electors for their state. 520-333-4578 is the number, and it's your turn. Whoever you may be out there, pick up the phone, dial it, 520-333-4578, and let's hear your view of what the hell's going on here. Because I got to tell you, tonight is important. Tomorrow is even more important, and however this election comes out is going to decide the future of this country. The future of the Constitution, the future of the Bill of Rights, the future of the right to keep and bear arms, the future of freedom of speech, the future of freedom of the press, the future of constitutional Republican government. It's going to decide, whether you believe it or not, it's the truth, it's going to decide the future of the world. And if Al Gore gets into the White House, we're doomed. We're screwed. We're history. This country is history. And you can take that in the bank and put it in an account. It's as good as gold. It's the truth. If George Bush gets in the White House, eventually the same thing is going to happen, but not as fast. Not as fast. See, the Republicans know their people, and they are the people who will fight the Civil War to restore a constitutional Republican government. So the Republicans aren't as rash or as foolish or as stupid as Democrats are, who are all full of Marxist philosophy up to their eyebrows and brimming over with the promise of the utopian world under socialism. They don't even see the danger. They don't even think that it could happen. They don't understand the psyche of the American people. They don't realize the purpose of the Founding Fathers pinning the second article and amendment. They don't realize the danger that they face from the people that they would enslave. People like me. 520-333-4578 is the number. Who are you going to vote for and why? And, you know, how do you think this is all going to play out? What do you think is going to happen here? I mean, this could be some serious stuff. What if Al Gore gets elected with Joseph Lieberman as a vice president? I'm telling you right now, there would be a serious movement amongst radical Zionists to bump Al Gore off so that Joseph Lieberman could assume the presidency and solve the Mideast crisis. Now, I'm not talking about Jews. I'm talking about radical people. Most Jews would be just as surprised as anybody else if that happened. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hi, Mr. Cooper.
Hi.
Hi. I have the date for the Electoral College.
Okay, what is it?
It says the first Monday after the second Wednesday in December.
Okay.
And it says the electors will vote by ballot. One for president, one for vice president.
Yeah. I know it wasn't any time near the actual election. It was way afterward.
Right.
But I didn't know the date. So it's the, say that again now?
It's the second Wednesday in December.
Okay.
I'm sorry. It's the first Monday after the second.
How'd you get second Wednesday when it's the first Monday? First Monday.
Let me read it again. It's the first Monday
after the second Wednesday. Okay.
In December. And actually, that works out to the 18th this year, I think, yeah.
After the second Wednesday.
It's the first Monday.
After the second Wednesday in December.
So the second Wednesday is December 13th.
So it'll be the 18th.
18th. Now, the one thing it doesn't say, it goes on to say that the votes go to Congress or the Senate.
Uh-huh.
And okay, the tally by Congress, right, and House of Representatives, a majority of 270 electoral votes is required, right? We know that.
That's correct.
But it doesn't say when they look at the ballots there, though. And it doesn't say,
Let me tell you what they've always done throughout modern history. They have announced the president right after the popular election. They haven't waited until the Electoral College voted. Now, does that tell you something? Does that tell you something?
Yeah.
What if they announce the president, next president of the United States, can be George Walker Bush, right after the popular election, and then they wait 2 months and announce, uh-oh, it's not Bush, it's Gore.
Huh.
Electoral College just voted Gore. That was a Freudian slip. I did not do that on purpose. I swear I didn't.
That it's all sick.
That, yeah. You better bet your butt it is. That's what I've been telling you for years.
Yeah.
Because, you see, if it's the Electoral College that decides the president, how could they do that?
Right.
How could they do it? Unless it's fixed.
Yeah.
Food for thought, huh?
Yes, it is.
Well, chew on that tonight. We're out of time.
All right.
I wish we weren't out of time, because this is one night that I wish we could take phone calls for, you know, another couple of hours. I really do. But, you know, we'll get to talk about this tomorrow night, and we will. And tomorrow night when we go on the air, most of the polls will be closed, and we'll know more about what's really going on. So thanks for calling.
All right. Bye-bye.
That's it, folks. Good night. God bless each and every single one of you. Good night, Annie Poon Allison. I love you.
All of a sudden, in the middle of the night, there's a loud knock on your door. Hey, honey. Something's not right.
Watch your hands. Things can fall past through. We're here from the government. We're here to help you.
And I'm from the IRS with a power to tax. If you've got a complaint...
Get out of this house. Surrender your charges. Give me your gold. You better obey if you want to come home. Get out of the first step and do what you're told.
Hillary Salala, Reno Janet Dyke, reading the words of General Albert Pike. Demonic founder of the Ku Klux Klan, engineer of the Masonic Master Plan. Pike said Lucifer is God across this land. And Clinton saying take the mark in your right hand. While we're all dancing to the drums of uproar strike, Clinton's preparing it for another huge tax hike. Order out of chaos, depression, inflation, create the panic and rape the nation.
Order.
Crisis creation. Incite black and white programs. Agitation.
Don't make this! You're surrounded! By the UN in white and blue, the ATF, the men in black, of the One World Order.
But it's not new.
Iron Mountain, computer beasts, and cattle mutilations. Black projects, UFOs, and weird genetic combinations. The Nazi doctors didn't die. Come on, get him. They came here with the OSS through Operation Paperclip. National ID, debit card? Yeah. Vaccination biochip, milk carton kits, genetic engineering. Clinton says her health plans for you and your own good. Sure. And Adolf Hitler's Robin Hood.
Order.
Masonic mind manipulation. Inciting riots is crisis creation.
Order.
biochip implantation. Vaccinate your kid for UN identification.
This is a test for all of us. So I have today just one simple request. A comprehensive package of healthcare benefits that are always there and can never be taken away. Never be taken away.
Atmospheric social illusion.
Good friends Anthony J. Hilder and Evan Sweetwater. Sweetwater Productions made this CD. Really good stuff. Of course, they're both very talented. Especially Evan, who writes all the music, performs every instrument, mixes all the music, and writes the lyrics and you know, produces the whole thing. I mean, he's just an incredible young man. He's busy producing some new music, all new music for the Hour of the Time, which you'll be hearing, I don't know when he gets it done, when I get it. Oh, once again, you're listening to the Hour of the Time. And it is the Hour of the Time. It's the most important hour in your whole life. And during this hour, you'll determine your future. And in a way, that sort of determines all of our future. I'm William Cooper. According to William Jefferson Clinton, in a White House memo, which Rush Limbaugh read on the air on his Excellence in Broadcasting Network, the most dangerous radio host in America. Can you believe what's going on out there? This is incredible. About 40 times an hour, somebody stands up somewhere and calls this great republic a democracy. About 40 times an hour. Bush representatives, Gore representatives, Florida state representatives, media talking heads, idiot professors from Marxist universities, and who knows what all. You know. They're damaging our democracy. They're damaging our democratic process. We have to go through this process so that our democracy can survive.
Gag me.
How did they live so long without ever hearing the Pledge of Allegiance? You know the one that says, to the republic for which it stands? To the republic for which it stands? And of course, they're all, you know, pretty prominent people, right? They've been around for a while. Many of them have served in government positions. And they all have taken oaths at one time in their life or other to protect and defend the Constitution for the United States of America against all enemies, foreign and domestic. Well, you know, when they talk like that, they turn out to be one of the enemies they're supposed to be protecting it from. In Article 4, Section 4. Article 4, Section 4, ladies and gentlemen. The United States shall guarantee to every state in this union a republican form of government. And every time I hear them, I just want to take up my copy of the Constitution, just smack them in the mouth with it, just as hard as I can. You know, stick it halfway down their throat. You know, they might be curious as to what it is that's lodged in their throat, and when they pull it out, they might be tempted to read it. That's the whole theory behind the urge that I have. Of course, I would never do such a thing. But I sure feel like it. Oh, boy, do I feel like it. This is what a disgusting debacle that's going on here. And they keep referring to, get this, folks. They don't even understand what's happening there. Here's what they say. I've heard it at least 20 times today from a whole bunch of different people. Oh, Professor So-and-so, can you believe that the vote of 275 million people all across this nation has boiled down to just a 259 vote difference? That's a bold-faced lie. At the time it was spoken, I don't have any idea what it is now, but at the time it was spoken, they were claiming that the popular vote count in the state of Florida, the difference between Gore's popular vote count and Bush's popular vote count was just 259 in favor of Bush. And they were trying to say that that was the total difference, the only difference between the votes of both of them, of the whole nation. Disgusting. And they keep repeating themselves over and over and over again ad nauseum until you're just sick of seeing the stuff and hearing it. And believe me, folks, if I didn't have to do these broadcasts, if I wasn't engaged in the great education of America that I'm set myself to try to do years ago, I wouldn't have listened to this stuff for longer than 5 minutes. It's just absolutely demoralizing and sickening, and the media, it is the media that is feeding this frenzy of democracy, which, of course, really means socialism. This whole thing is targeted at the Constitution for the United States of America. It is designed to destroy the republic by taking another big chunk out of it, out of its checks and balances, out of its integrity, out of its greatness, and it's absolutely disgusting. I can't stand it. And not only that, but all the networks are lying to us again. I mean, just bold-faced giving us rumors. All day long, they've been telling us that they've been giving us these numbers from these counties, and people think that these are the official certified numbers of the state of Florida, and they're not. They're rumors. Rumors. You see, I happened to be watching today when it was 53 counties out of 67 counties reporting Bush had 900 and something votes, and Gore had, you know, 900 and something votes ahead, and Gore was losing. Well, at 5:10 p.m. this afternoon, the Secretary of State of the state of Florida, long after this 53 counties supposedly reported to the networks, held a press conference. That was at 5:10 p.m. And she said that at that time, when all the networks were reporting 62 counties, the official vote, which again, it's just rumor, it's all bullshit, the Secretary of State of the state of Florida said at 5:10 p.m., while all of the networks, BSNBC, CNN, NBC, ABC, all of them, CNN, were reporting 62 counties were in, and the difference between the vote count was only something like 305. Here's what she said. She said, as of this moment, 5:10 p.m., only 53 counties have officially reported their recount to the Office of the Secretary of State out of 67 counties. And here is the results so far. The candidate, George W. Bush, is ahead of Al Gore by 1,784 votes. Got that, sheeple? So all day, the networks have been lying to us again. 1,784 votes is exactly the number of votes that George Bush was ahead on Tuesday when the count became official from the state of Florida. So while all these lying networks, all these talking, brainless, witless heads are endlessly spouting their democracy bullshit, telling us hours before this, when they said 53 counties had reported their official results, that George W. Bush was only ahead by 900 and something votes. And at the time that the Secretary of State of the state of Florida made her announcement, at 5:10 p.m. this evening, they were saying that 62 counties had reported their results and the difference was only 305 votes in Bush's favor and dwindling fast. That was at 5:10 p.m. The same time when the Secretary of State of the state of Florida said this, at this moment, only 53 counties have reported their official results to the Office of the Secretary of State. That's 5:10 p.m. my time, folks. Out of 67 total counties, George Bush leads with 1,784 votes. When are you going to stop listening to these people? They're the biggest liars on the face of this earth. And you know why they're all wrong? And you know why they're all reporting the same numbers all at the same time? Because they don't send out reporters to do all of these things anymore. They have what they call correspondents in the field. And they may only have one or two correspondents anywhere in the field because that's all they can afford to pay them these days because they got to make big profits from their news divisions. So they get all of their statistics and all of the other stories and all of this other stuff from Associated Press, and every single one of them are getting these numbers from Associated Press. Remember Associated Press? Remember AP? Remember the Oklahoma City bombing? Remember the first casualty figures from the Oklahoma City bombing that AP let out to the world were the exact same casualty figures of the Branch Davidians? Ladies and gentlemen, on April the 19th, 1995. Remember that? When they said 86 people were dead and 17 children? You know why they did it? They were propagandizing the American people, trying to equate the Oklahoma City bombing with the Waco massacre. They blatantly lied, and they're lying now. They've always lied. They lied about what was going on at Waco. Over and over and over and over and over, AP is the worst. There's two that are the worst places to get your news from. The very worst. All of them are bad. All of them are bad, but these two are the very worst. Associated Press and ABC News. Those are the worst in the world. Associated Press and ABC News. They've been caught in more lies than anybody else that does the news, and they're all liars. All of them. And MSNBC has a new name. It is no longer MSNBC, it's BSNBC. 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 From now on, you will not refer to that stinking, propagandizing, lying network as MSNBC. You will, from here on forever, refer to them as BSNBC. That's an order. Just joking, folks. But that's what you ought to be doing. Seriously. I've been listening to lies all day long. All day long, it just gets so sickening. And listening to these dear, sweet little old ladies who've been rounded up by the Democrat Party to sit in front of the cameras and tell their little stories. They're people's mothers and grandmothers and aunts. And they're just as sweet as could be, and if you knew them, you'd probably just love them to death, no matter who the hell they are. But they're senior citizens. We all know what happens when you begin to get old, and it's going to happen to all of us. You don't think as quickly or as accurately, nor are you as thorough in what you do. I have some of these little old ladies in my family. I know some of these little old ladies. I love them to death. But you got to help them out on some things. And things get confusing to them. And when they could program a VCR maybe 20 years ago or 15 years ago or maybe even 10 years ago, they can't do it now. And yeah, ballots confuse them. And it wouldn't matter what kind of ballot you gave them. And that's the truth, and you all know it. Stand behind one of them in a supermarket line sometime. And you, pretty soon, you make up your mind that it's better to stand in the line that's three times longer that doesn't have any sweet little old ladies in it than to stand in that line. And wait for her to find her pennies and her nickels and find her checkbook and then find her pen. And then take 15 minutes to fill out a check. And then she has to examine the check and go over it again and look at it and hold it up to the light. And then she has to find her ID card. And then, you know, see what she gets. She has to count every penny of her change. And there's nothing wrong with this. Folks, it's life. It's life. Now, some people grow into their older years without a lot of these problems. But most people don't. Most people have these problems, men and women. It's not just the little old ladies. It's a lot of little old men, too. Many of them are on the edges of or in the beginning of stages of Alzheimer's disease. We all know that. And so to sit there and watch them tell their sad tale about going into the voting booth and you know, you look at the ballot. It's in big type. Every name has an arrow pointing exactly directly to the place where you're supposed to poke the hole. And you listen to their tale of woe, how they got so confused and couldn't find the arrow and didn't know where to poke, so they poked one hole, and then they figured they made a mistake. So instead of taking their ballot over to the person and saying, I screwed up my ballot, can I have another one? Which is okay, you can do that. They don't want to embarrass themselves, so they poke another hole and invalidate their ballot. And then they go out and they're holding it so nobody can see they poke two holes in the ballot and they stick it in the box and walk away so nobody has to know about it. And then after the candidate loses and the Democrat Party makes a big deal out of it and all of the precinct wardens and all of the Democrat officials go around, you know, trying to stir up trouble and find out if there were any irregularities, they find these little old ladies and little old men and get them to come forward and tell their story of woe. I feel sorry for them because they're being used. And I know absolutely that they're being used, ladies and gentlemen, because in the last election in 1996, there wasn't even near the turnout that there was in this election. In this election, there were 19,000 ballots that were disqualified because the people who filled them out poked two holes in them and voted for two different people for the same office. That is against the law. It automatically renders a ballot no good. Now, I'm not picking on Democrats because I don't want George Bush in there either. You got to understand that. I'm just interested in the truth, and this is the truth. 19,000 this time. Last time in 1996, there were 16,000. 16,000 of those people did the same thing in 1996. Same thing. On a different kind of ballot. It was not this ballot. Different kind of ballot. So this is all bullshit. They're using these people. Of course, these people don't know it. They think they're contributing to democracy. Oh, we got to make this right. I was confused. Of course you're confused. You're confused at just about everything you do when you get that old. I hope I don't get confused like that when I get that old, but I got to tell you, statistics say that I probably will. And statistics say that all of you out there listening probably will also. It's the truth. You don't want to be behind or in front of or beside any of these people when they're driving on the road. They get on a highway where the speed limit's 75 miles an hour and they go 25 miles an hour and they cause accidents. They go halfway past the intersection where they want to make a turn and then they make it. And people are running to get out of the way and dodging and running up on the grass and stuff. I mean, they're dangerous when they're operating machinery. We all know it. We see it every day in our lives. So why is it all of a sudden a surprise that these senior citizens, whom we all love and care about, get confused in the voting booth and put their ballot twice? And I think it's a crime to be using them in this way. I really do. I really do. And a lot of other things. I mean, I could go on and on and on and on and on and on and on about this stuff. And I got to tell you, it's happened in every single state. Every state. And in every community where there's a lot of senior citizens, there's a lot of ballots thrown out because they were punched twice. Don't believe me? Go check with your local election board. You want to really see a whole bunch of ballots that were punched twice? Go to Sun City in Arizona. The biggest senior community in Arizona, you'll see more ballots punched twice than they ever dreamed of in West Palm Beach, Florida. And thrown out. A little Colombian coffee here, folks. State of New Mexico is still counting their votes. They've got it marked for Gore. But the election is not official in New Mexico. It's not over. And Gore may not win it. Big discrepancies in Colorado, Wisconsin, Michigan, a lot of other states, California. You want to recount some votes? They need to send the United States Army to California and recount that whole state. And they need to have Immigration and Naturalization Service go over each of those ballots and go round up all those illegal aliens and, you know, shove them back across the border where they came from and invalidate all of their votes. I mean, if you want to really get down and dirty, let's do a recount in every state, but along with the recount, let's validate the registration and citizenship of every person who voted, and let's make sure that they're still alive. Because I guarantee you, in the state of Illinois, as happens in every presidential election, a lot of voters came directly from the cemetery. And their address is 6 feet down. Same as Arkansas, if you believe the governor of that state. And I believe him, 100%. I don't think he was lying to us at all. I think he told us the truth. 100% true. Everything he said.
What he said about Arkansas.
Whoa. Man, wasn't Al Gore listening when this guy was on the Don Imus show telling the truth about voting in his state? If I was Al Gore, I'd be in Arkansas next, because that went to George Bush. I'd be demanding another vote count in the state of Arkansas. Wouldn't do any good, though, because Arkansas is a Democrat. And the Democrats are the dirtiest, stinkingest, most crookedest, criminal vote scam, vote fraud artists that have ever lived. Now, don't get me wrong again, because the Republican Party has done its share of vote fraud. But nobody in the history of the world has ever done anything near vote fraud like the Democrat Party always has done in its history and is still doing today everywhere. Can you believe? And nobody's talking about this in a state with 58 electors. What's the matter with George Bush? Has George Bush got a brain? Why in the world would we want him in the White House when he's allowing them to get away with taking California with a vote from illegal aliens who were pre-registered by the Democrat Party, sent a letter signed by President William Jefferson Clinton, including a voter registration card with their name and a phony address on it, telling them to report to a certain poll on Tuesday to cast their vote in their new country? And George W. Bush isn't saying a word about that, is he? And you want him in the White House? In my estimation, California ought to be under martial law right now. Because of that little stunt. And all of the officials of the Democrat Party and William Jefferson Clinton for allowing his name to be put on the bottom of that letter ought to be in prison right now. Right this minute. You think that's ever going to happen? No. Because this whole thing is a sham. It's a scam. It's orchestrated. And George Bush don't give a damn about the 58 electoral votes in California, because that's not what this election is all about. It's about destroying the checks and balances and the constitutional protections of this country and the electoral process. It's to destroy the Electoral College. It's to institute in this country real democracy, something the Founding Fathers were scared to death of. And America's watching it and participating in it. They have big demonstrations down in West Palm Beach. Listen to some stupid jerk, you know, he knew the camera was on him, so he's just yelling, "This is a democracy! It's the will of the people! To hell with the law! It's the will of the people! If the law is against the will of the people, then you got to change the law!" He's just screaming this. No, it's a republic. And a republic is instituted under the rule of law. Governed and limited and protected by the Constitution and the Bill of Rights and the amendments thereto. So that all citizens are equally protected and looked after. And the integrity of the election process is preserved in the Electoral College, because that's what the Electoral College is for. You see, if the electors from all of the states determine that there was a great injustice rendered to either one of the candidates in the state of Florida, they, as statesmen appointed to elect the president on December the 18th, will do the right thing. That's what they're for. You see, the people do not and never have in this country ever voted for the president or the vice president. They are voting for electors. That's another thing that makes me so sad, watching these poor people down in Florida saying, "I was denied the right to vote because I punched the ballot twice because I was confused. And I didn't, my vote was not cast for my presidential candidate." Well, number one, dear, my dear sweet lady, my dear sweet grandma. Your right to vote was preserved. You went to the polling place and you got your ballot and you went into the voting booth and you had your right to vote. You screwed it up. You screwed up the ballot. You blew it. Nobody took away your right to vote. And what you were voting for was never your choice of a presidential candidate. Not ever, even though you're voting for his name on a form that is a scam. It's always been a scam in this country to even think, for any American, to even think or believe for one moment that they're voting for their presidential candidate or their vice presidential candidate. You are voting for an elector. That's what you're voting for. So, my dear, I'm sorry, but I have to be the one to tell you this. And it may hurt your feelings because, as a senior citizen, in your sunset years, it's pretty hard to learn that you've been lied to all your life and you're going to resist it. You're not going to even want to hear it. And you're going to rant and rail against me or anyone else who tries to tell you the truth about what's really happening. And it will make you cry and you'll go home and you'll be angry for days. But after it's all over, after it's all said and done, after you've railed and ranted and beat on the wall and called me and other people names, it will still be the truth. It will still be the truth. And no matter how much you may think it's a bad truth, it's a good truth. It's one of the checks and balances our founding fathers gave us to save us in instances like this. To save us from demagogues. To save us from the mob. To make sure that the right person, at least as far as those who run, goes into the White House. Because I'm going to tell you right now that on December the 18th, the Electoral College could, if they wanted to, put Ralph Nader in the White House. And that's the truth. And even this listening audience didn't believe any of this. I remember the first night that I came on the radio and started telling you the truth about the Electoral College, and call after call after call after caller called me a liar. And there are still people left over from those broadcasts still sending me letters and still calling me a liar, telling me that the electors must vote absolutely for whoever is elected in their district or their state by the popular vote. Now, the experts have been on the television networks all day today and all day yesterday, and they've been telling you the truth. They don't have to. They don't have to. You see, the only participation of the state in the electoral process is the state gets to choose the electors any way they wish. It is a function of the legislature of the state that is appointing the electors. Once the state appoints the elector, it is federal jurisdiction. The state has nothing to say or do about any of it. It's constitutionally mandated according to the Constitution for the United States and the amendments that have affected the electoral process, and they can vote any damn way they choose for anybody that they choose who has qualified and run to be the president of the United States of America. And I'm not so sure that they couldn't reach out and choose somebody who didn't even run as long as they qualified or met the qualifications outlined in the Constitution that the president must fulfill in order to become president. It's never happened. But I'm not so sure that it couldn't, because I can't find anywhere in the Constitution where it's prohibited at all. And if it's not prohibited, it can be done. Isn't this amazing? My good friend Jeffrey, whom has been a dear listener and a dear friend for years, and I still consider him to be a dear friend, is still fighting this battle. trying to make me believe that the electors must vote for the popular vote in their state. It's not true. Not true at all. And he's not the only one. Not the only one. Jeffrey's problem is that he is seeing impaired, which is just another politically correct way of saying that he's blind. And so he can't pick up the Constitution and read it for himself. He must ask other people what it says. And unfortunately, not too many people know what it says or tell the truth about what it says. All of you who have good eyes don't have that problem. And I still know that most of the listeners to this broadcast still do not have their own copy of the Constitution, although you should. I've been railing at you for years to get a copy of the Constitution. The Constitution defines the nation. Bill Clinton is not the nation. Washington, D.C. is not the nation. The nation is not some weird geographic boundary. I used to see these bumper stickers back during the Vietnam era that said, "My country, love it or leave it." It's not a geographic boundary that you can love or leave. It's a set of principles and ideals enshrined in three basic documents. The Declaration of Independence, also known as the Unanimous Declaration of the 13 Colonies. The Articles of Confederation. And the Constitution for the United States of America, which includes, ladies and gentlemen, the Bill of Rights. The Bill of Rights are not separate from the Constitution. The founders would not adopt nor accept the Constitution for the United States of America and would not ratify it until the Bill of Rights were penned and included as an integral part of that document. So when you refer to the Constitution for the United States of America and the Bill of Rights as two separate documents, you are flagellating yourself. You are making a big mistake. They are not. They are one document. And unless I open the phones, don't call. It's always been my rule. And while I'm on that subject, folks, there's only one time when you're justified in calling me, and that's between 12 noon my time and 5 p.m. my time, Monday through Friday. I've said this over and over and over and over again. If you call me before noon, unless it's a real emergency, I'm going to be rude and I'm going to hang up on you. Call me after 5 p.m. and it's not a real emergency, I'm going to be rude and I'm going to hang up on you. Call me on Saturday or Sunday or during the night or any time if it's not a real emergency, I'm going to be very rude to you and I'm going to hang up on you. Because you're an inconsiderate slob, you wouldn't even think of calling Rush Limbaugh at home. Ever. Or Larry King, or G. Gordon Liddy, or anybody else. I give you a time that you can call me at home, and most of you adhere to that. Some of you are just absolute asses, have no consideration whatsoever. And call me at 3 o'clock in the morning, 6 o'clock in the morning, 10 o'clock at night, 5, 2 minutes before the broadcast, right after the broadcast, and I will not tolerate it, period. So don't. If you're not guilty, I'm not talking to you. Those of you who are guilty, you know I'm talking to you. You see, there was a time when I used to let people call me at any time. And everybody had my address, and everybody had my home phone number. And it was abused. I couldn't go to sleep for 5 minutes, the phone would ring. 2 o'clock in the morning, some jerk with pink hair and rings in his ears and in his nose and his eyelids would be banging on the door, claiming that he was abducted by some aliens or something. And so one day I just got sick of that crap, and I said, no more. No more. We're going to open the phones now. Now you can call. Now we'll talk about, and let's keep it to the election, folks. 520-333-4578. Is the number. Good evening, you're on the air.
Hi, Mr. Cooper.
Hello.
You're a fan of backwards magazine?
Backwoods Home magazine.
Yeah, Backwoods Home magazine.
Yes.
There's an article in there by John Silveri, or Silveria, on the coming American dictatorship, and I think that's something that your audience out there should look up and read. It's a very good article.
Well, if they want to be self-sufficient and live through the hard times that are going to come, regardless if they come tomorrow, they don't come for another 8 or 9 or 12 years, they should be reading Backwoods Home magazine anyway.
Well, I was at a power breakfast here for businessmen here in the Houston area.
Power breakfast. Yeah, when I was a corporate executive, I remember those well.
Yeah.
Wear your blue blazer with the you had to have always more than 3 gold buttons on the sleeve, because 3 gold buttons is common working class. You had to have 4, 5, or 6 gold buttons.
Right.
And of course that
you were part of the fascist.
Yeah. Thing. You had to have your red or burgundy tie and your beautiful button down shirt. And
yeah.
Your wingtips and your nice, beautiful little gray slacks. And yeah, I remember.
Well,
I remember those power
election and everything.
Yeah.
And I'm over there talking to my end of the table with different guys, and one fellow leans over and he told me that I was completely out of my mind. And I stood up and I banged my glass and I started to tell him what you've been talking about tonight.
Uh-huh.
And people started telling me that I was wrong. And I said, look, I've got $1,000 in my pocket in cash right now, and I'll bet anybody here that I'm right and that you're wrong. In fact, I'll put all my possessions up, and all you have to do is prove me wrong. And not one of those men would take that challenge up.
Oh, then you became the most powerful man at the meeting at that moment.
Not one of them.
That's when you became the most powerful man at that meeting at that moment. And they all showed themselves for what they are.
Exactly. And I said, y'all are just a bunch of boys. And that was, when I sat down and I finished my breakfast and I left.
Yeah.
I didn't have any, I won't go back to this again. And that is the condition.
Why not? You should.
Leadership in our country.
Why? No, no, no.
Huh?
That's the wrong idea. You should go back. You should go
well,
to
maybe
the,
I will go back.
Well, listen to me now. You should go to the next meeting and take a copy of the Constitution for every single one of them and highlight with a yellow highlighter all of the pertinent points that prove what you told them the last time.
Okay, well, I will do that.
And do that. And say,
I'll go
you know,
a quick copy and do that tomorrow.
Yeah, say, I'm your friend, and this is for your education, and you'll be a better man if you read it.
And so, you remember, I called a couple of weeks ago, and I said that I thought that they were going to even up this thing and make a big shebang out of it. You know, with the intent of calling for, well, I said a constitutional convention. And of course, remember, you reminded us about speculation.
Yeah.
Say if we were speculating, and that's good.
Yeah. And there will not be a constitutional convention.
No, it was an amendment.
There will be amendments, yes.
An amendment to this. And that has been the whole exercise.
You're right.
All this crap that's going on.
You're absolutely correct.
And you know what's interesting? I've read articles from everywhere you can imagine from around the country over the last year, and they have been working up toward this little by little. So you know what? It is a conspiracy in concert by both parties.
Absolutely, and I knew that this was coming, and I knew that there was a big clash coming months ago when they first started talking about, guess what, the Electoral College, which they had never discussed in the history of any election that's ever occurred in this country in my entire life.
And you're right. I've watched the election process going all the way back. I can remember back during the Carter administration, and never one time did they ever bring up the Electoral College until this election.
Nope. They always announced the winner by popular vote. It was always the popular vote. It was always the big scam of the popular vote.
Well, y'all remember out there to get that article, The Coming American Dictatorship. I think that the article is very well-rounded in where this is going. I mean, he makes a remark about, everybody wants less taxes and less government, and we vote the same people back in the office every year.
Everybody wants whatever they can get from whoever they can get it from. We have turned into a nation of materialistic, greedy bastards, and that's the truth.
We've turned into a bunch of materialistic masochists.
Well, my book, that's the same as A Greedy Bastard. Anyway, I got to let you go. Thanks for calling. 520-333-4578 is the number. I'll be taking your calls for the rest of the hour. Good evening. You're on the air.
Hey, Bill. This is Bill in North Carolina.
Howdy. I
wanted to point out a couple of things to you.
Sure.
I saw on CBS News, I've noticed one word that has always been linked with the word electoral college. That word is antiquated. Have
yes.
you noticed that?
Yes. You'll see that in my article on the website. I also use the word antiquated, referring to what you just said.
Well, there's one thing here that you were talking about, the popular vote being cast in New Mexico, not complete.
Yeah.
CBS News reported tonight that the popular vote will not be finished until Thanksgiving in Oregon. So there's another one there that we can look forward to.
Yep.
And
there's a lot of absentee ballots for Oregon, too. And I'm not talking about the ones that the citizens mail in. I'm talking about ones from out of the country.
Yeah, they were saying the problem there was that people were not actually mailing them in, that they were just simply turning them in late. They showed a visual of the...
Well, what do you expect? What do you expect from a bunch of hippies?
Well, you know.
Now, I don't mean that about everybody in the state of Oregon, but I got to tell you, a lot of the what we used to call hippies are now living in Oregon. I got to tell you that. It's true.
Well, you know, the Electoral College, the people that are voting, isn't that or is that not a secret ballot?
Well, it's a secret ballot when they vote, but it's made public because they have to present it to the Congress.
Okay. Well, Dan Rather on CBS News tonight said that in the history of this nation, there have only been 7 electors that have swayed in history, and never has it affected the outcome. That's not true.
Well, it isn't true. It absolutely is not true, because it did affect the outcome at least twice that I'm aware of.
The elections of 1876 and 1888.
That's absolutely correct.
And, did you hear that the NAACP had written to Janet Reno asking for U.S. Marshals down in Florida? Thought that was pretty good.
Well, I sent them to Florida. They better not come up here.
Yep.
Hey, I'll tell you that right now.
One more quick thing, and I'll let somebody else get in there. Did you hear today that Dan Forth had absolved all the guys about Waco?
That what now?
Dan Forth. You know, he was leading up the Waco investigation.
Well, that wasn't. He did that months ago.
Okay. Well, they had a piece in USA.
And now they filed charges against one of the members of the Justice Department that blew the whistle on him.
Yes, Bill Johnston is
yeah.
his name.
Yep. They're going to prosecute him. Can you believe that?
It's unbelievable. But you know, this whole thing about democracy has really got me upset, and it's had me upset for several weeks now before the election.
It's okay. Madame Defarge is knitting furiously. Furiously.
Well, you know, it amazes me, Bill. I stand there with the Constitution literally in my hand, open to Article 4, Section 4, and I tell these people, I say, your vote doesn't matter. We don't have a democracy.
That's right.
And I swear to God, I'll get you a fist fight just about every time. You
that's
know?
Because they're stupid. They're thinking you're stupid when it's them that's stupid. They've never even checked. They take what they hear as being truth.
It's amazing to me. I don't know if we're all going to wake up in time or not.
Well, we're not. I've told you that already. It's going to be a civil war in this country. It's gone past the point that there's ever going to be, or ever can be, or you can even think of having a political resolution to what's going on.
Well,
if we're going to restore a constitutional Republican government, it's going to be with the force of arms, and that's why the Founding Fathers gave us the second article and amendment, so that we would have those tools when we needed them.
Well, I certainly hope you have a good evening. I got guns to clean.
Thanks.
I'll see you later.
Thanks for calling. 520-333-4578 is the number. Good evening. You're on the air.
Yeah, Bill. This is John in Houston.
Hi, John.
I've had the same problem with these media yo-yos on the Houston television stations. Every other day, I'm having to call one of them up and tell them, show me where the Constitution says that we're a democracy.
Ask them to show you anywhere in the Constitution where that word even appears once.
Exactly. I remind them that not only Article 4, Section 4 of the United States Constitution, but Article 1, Section 2 of the Texas Constitution, each guarantees us a Republican form of government.
That's
and
correct.
And I offer to give them $100 if they can find the word democracy mentioned once in either the Texas or the United States Constitution, and yet those brainless idiots, those twits that they have, these talking heads, who are doing the local news here in Houston on virtually every station, democracy, democracy, over and over again.
Yeah.
And I agree with you that I think that this whole charade that's going on in Florida is an attempt to destroy the last vestige of a Republican form of government by getting rid of the Electoral College.
Yeah, they got rid of the state legislatures appointing the senators and thus did away with the sovereignty, or at least chipped away at the sovereignty of the states. And now they want to get rid of the last protection that we have that saves us against a dictatorship, and that's the Electoral College.
You bet. And another thing is that I want to tell people that anyone who's ever watched Jay Leno, in spite of all of his faults, he had a really good thing on a couple of nights ago. If you want to know why so many people are so brain dead to vote for the likes of Al Gore, Jay Leno went to one of the colleges in the country. I forgot where he said it was, but he actually, you could see him there. This was not a gag or a routine.
Yeah, I know. He does it all the time. He goes out in the street and asks people questions.
And he went to this college and asked a number of different college students questions like, who attacked us at Pearl Harbor? Well, the young lady didn't know.
Yeah.
He asked the young man, well, when was the Civil War fought? Well, he didn't know. He thought first the 1840s and then the 1880s. No, you dumbass. It was 1861.
Yeah, I know. Well, let's not get off on a tangent on this, okay?
Yeah.
We're talking about the election, not Jay Renner.
One particular question after another about civics and history and things like that, none of these idiots knew.
Yeah.
Like MacArthur's thing.
I know, but I've said it twice now. I'm not going to say it again. Get off this subject. That's not the subject of tonight's conversation.
That's why when these idiots spout off democracy, and I've asked people before, I've gone to speak before organizations before, I've spoken before high schools, and I asked these kids, I asked them, well, what form of government do you have? And I've even asked people who are taking government classes in college, and, oh, we're a democracy. No.
Yeah.
Have you ever read the Constitution? Well, sure I have. Well, I said, well, you better go back and read it
again.
Well,
in the first place, when they say, well, sure I have, they're lying through their teeth.
Sure.
They're lying through that they never read it. I guarantee you they never read it.
They maybe looked at the cover, but that was about
it. Well, I guarantee you they didn't even look at the cover. There isn't any cover on the Constitution to start with, and that tells me something about you.
Well, no, I'm...
520-333-45. See? You always get caught if you try to bullshit me. Cover on the Constitution. Can you believe that? This guy is berating other people because they didn't read the Constitution. He's talking about the cover on the Constitution. There is no cover on the Constitution. 520-333-4578 is the number. Good evening. You're on the air.
Bill, this is Wayne from North Carolina. I was feeling a little bad last night. I feel good tonight, so I feel like talking. The one thing, I've had all my other thunder stolen by you and other callers, but you know what tonight we're doing that I don't think anybody said? We're demonstrating to the world that our system of transition of power is just laying in flames in front of everybody tonight all around the world, and I think it's absolutely disgusting.
Well, it is disgusting.
They're all watching us.
It is disgusting, but this is not our system of transition.
But you know what I mean.
I'm telling you,
around the world.
Here's what happens. Florida doesn't mean dip. The electoral college is going to meet on December the 18th with or without Florida's electors, and they're going to elect a president.
Okay.
So all that's going on down there is all bullshit. The electoral college is going to meet. Listen to me, folks. They're going to meet on December the 18th with are without the electors from the state of Florida as required by the don't interrupt me on my own show, okay?
Sorry.
As required by the Constitution for the United States of America and the United States Code. And they're going to elect a president with or without the electors from the state of Florida. Now you can talk.
I apologize for interrupting, Mr.
Go ahead. Remember, this is my broadcast, not yours.
Absolutely. And I love it. I'm just kind of embarrassed for us tonight around the world as folks watch this stuff. That was my main point for calling in, and you're absolutely correct, though, by the way. That's all I had, Bill.
Well,
you have a good evening.
Thank you for your call.
Thank you.
520-333-4578 is the number. Remember, folks, when you call, you're a guest on my free speech radio. It's not yours. Good evening. You're on the air.
Good evening, sir. A report, if you will allow me. I was coming home this evening and listening to a local AM radio station in Mobile, Alabama, so that any of your listeners that are interested can call and check out what I'm about to tell you.
Okay.
I consider what I heard to probably be a trial balloon and was quite surprised because in this part of the country, you don't generally hear the kind of information that you're trying to get out to the listeners. The local talk show host was even somewhat surprised himself, and I loved every minute of it because it sort of woke people up. This is the gist of the story. You will help me if you recognize the name of the institute that the gentleman on the other end of the phone represented. It was the Jimmy Carter and the South African leader Institute for Peace, blah, blah, blah.
Mm-hmm.
And the giveaway was that he described his organization as being fellow travelers.
Yeah, that's communist.
Hey, absolutely. And, well, it was a beautiful little flag, and I appreciate you for educating us to how to catch on to the lingo and phrases that they use. Anyway, to get to the punchline on this, the gentleman was quite comfortable in trying to get our local good old boy radio host comfortable with the idea that what they needed to do in South Florida, and he was quite serious, was send in United Nations troops to secure democracy.
Yeah.
Well, I thought about it for a few minutes and said, he's got to be BSing. Let's stick with it and see if he can convince my local good old boys. Well, this is hunting and fishing country.
If they send United Nations troops anywhere in the United States, I will be loaded up with all my combat gear, and I will be on the way to kill those bastards as soon as I get close enough to shoot them.
That was the gist of the several local calls, at least from southern Alabama, was that idiot. If you think you're going to send those boys down there, you're going to have some dead boys with blue helmets on their head.
Lots of dead boys with blue helmets on their head.
The gentleman eventually hung up because he was trying to catch a plane to hurry up and get to South Florida. Whether or not...
He better catch a plane out of the country.
Exactly, but I felt like in light of where I am and relative to the kind of information that makes it out in this market, that may have in fact been a trial balloon. I hope your listeners will enjoy checking me out on this one, because if the guy that did the show answers the phone, he'll give them an earful, and that's all I have.
Okay, thanks for calling.
Good night, sir.
And that's it, folks, for another amazing episode of the Hour of the Time, the last bastion of free speech and truth in probably the whole world. And I, William Cooper, sitting behind this microphone, the most dangerous radio host in America, am probably the last free man existing upon the face of this earth. Good night. God bless each and every single one of you. Good night, Annie, Pooh, and Allison. I love you.
All of a sudden, in the middle of the night, there's a loud knock on your door. Hey, honey. Something's not right.
You're out your hands. Let me not walk past the room. We're here for the government. We're here to help you.
And I'm from the IRS with a power to tax. If you've got a complaint, send us the facts.
Get out of this house. Surrender your prizes. Give me your gold. You better obey if you want to come home. That's the best I can do when you're told.
Hillary Shalala, Reno Janet Dyke, reading the words of General Albert Pike, demonic founder of the Ku Klux Klan, engineer of the Masonic Master Plan. Pike said Lucifer is God across this land, and put in saying take the mark in your right hand. While we're all dancing to the drums of Buffalo Bright, Clinton's preparing it for another huge tax hike. Order out of chaos, depression, inflation, create the panics and rape the nation. Crisis creation. Incite black and white programs. Agitation.
Don't resist! You're surrounded! By the UN in white and gray, the ATF, the men in black, of the one world order.
But it's not new.
Iron Mountain, computer beasts, and cattle mutilations. Black projects, UFOs, and weird genetic combinations. The Nazi doctors didn't die. Come on, get him.
They came here with the OSS, your Operation Paperclip. National ID, debit card? Yeah. Vaccination biochip, milk carton kit, genetic engineering. Clinton says her health plans for you and your own good. Sure. And Adolf Hitler's Robin Hood. Masonic mind manipulation. Inciting riots is crisis creation. Biochip implantation. Vaccinate your kid for UN identification.
This is a test for all of us. So I have today just one simple request. A comprehensive package of healthcare benefits that are always there and can never be taken away.
Atmospheric. Social illusion. Media hype. Plan confusion.
Masonic religion. It's a liar. Got you praying for a Luciferian Messiah.
The Illuminati thinks that they're enlightened, that they're to be the gods to earth, born of incest from the sons of Satan and their sisters in satanic birth. Hidden agenda, Kissinger, Nixon, Ford, and Bill. While your kids out back smoking crack for some cheap thrill. They've numbed us down and dumbed us down with fluoride TV drugs, the NEA, and public schools. They've taken your brightest and our best and made them public schools. With managed media, brain-bending lies and stealth, the banksters stole your wealth. Johnson, Bush, Carter, Reagan, Gore, and Dan, they've all been pushing pipes, but by master plan. Rhodes Scholar oration. Clinton speaks and rakes the nation. Luciferian subjugation. New World Order. Illuminati coronation.
Media grand ovation.
Orders of the quest. Think they're superior. They think that they're the best.
And you're inferior, you little bat.
Skull and Bones, Skull and Key, Knight Templar, Harvard University.
Every Faustian fraternity.
Knights of the Golden Circle, Ancient Order of the Rosen Cross, CFR, Albatross.
And the party, Rockefeller Spot.
MK Ultra, ISA from the OSS to the CIA.
Mass murder is the game they play.
Galileo, NASA, Jupiter, Plutonium 2000.
Fuel sun. They'll call it Lucifer. Or what?
Pyramid Giza. Hitler called it a Luciferian millennium.
1,000
points of light.
Lava Rome, Thunderdome, Isaac Clark, Luke, and Cut. If the UN lives, y'all don't bust.
Wake up, Jupiter, read the scoop.